Your mics are hot.
Mic's hot.
Yeah. Hot mic. I'd rather be a N-I-G-G-A.
You guys want to talk to the camera? That's your guys' camera right here? So you guys want to talk directly to the
camera? I'd rather be a Negro.
When Paul is playing videos on here, I can't swap the camera. So any comments you guys have about the video, just save until the video is done. So then
hey, can you make sure if somebody comments that we see?
Because if I switch the video, you guys won't be able to hear the audio.
What's wrong? The remix.
That issue.
The remix. Everybody got a drink.
I'm Gucci.
Are you back? You back?
Like I back, never huh? left. You they got back. The Don over there. Get y'all some drinks for the show start. It's the perfect time to do
you
it.
You go back, I go off.
You now you done.
Yeah.
You going to church? You
after, give the, your... after the birthday, I was done.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, you got the stream key?
You giving your life to Christ?
I've been on that.
This nigga went Muslim, bro.
gotta give up the
nigga drop an album and go Muslim. That's crazy work. All right, we talking about Diddy early or late? Oh, it's right here.
You already tested the phone?
Yeah, he good. He can hear himself.
I want to talk to Samson. Take me to the moon. Let's see. I'd rather be. What we doing? Just audio. I'd rather be Ooh. You ready to be interviewed, Sissy Pooh?
I guess.
I can't say you my sissy yet.
Okay.
Sean don't want to reveal who you are yet.
secrets.
More secrets? What I need from you.
I like surprises. You know I like surprises.
I know. I hate them.
Ooh, yeah. It ain't surprising you.
Well, now I got to just shut up. Like.
Why you got to shut up? speak your truth.
Why you got to shut up?
Speak your truth.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
That's what it is.
All right.
You want to say in the beginning? You feel better just saying in the beginning?
I'd rather be a Negro.
It's nice what you want
to
do.
You say whatever comes to your mind. We do not give a fuck. We are unhinged.
Unhinged.
I'm down.
I need another shot. You know that. Let me take another sip of my drink.
You got this whiteboard tonight.
Who made Casamigos? This Clooney?
Yep.
Don't The Rock got one?
Mm-hmm.
That's terrible.
It's all on the batch that you get because they make it in small batches.
Oh, okay.
So
the Terramana?
Yes.
I got an ass batch.
You got an ass batch.
That shit itched.
Sorry.
Like it was going down. It felt like it was like little niggas punching me on the throat on the way down. it was so rough. So rough. I had Deli on.
Okay.
And that shit was smooth. Yeah. Must have a good batch.
Well,
no. What's the Kevin Hart
Is that Diddy's?
Damn.
Damn. No cap. I thought that was 50 Cent tequila.
Nah.
Don't 50 got one too?
Yeah
but not that one.
What's 50 Cent tequila?
He doesn't have tequila. He got a
vodka or something, right?
Oh, yeah.
A vodka.
Oh, okay.
He's still with Jim Beam right now.
Yeah, I hope he wins. Damn.
So which one did Diddy
want? I've been sipping on that Diddy, that Deleon.
Oh, the Deleon?
That shit smooth as hell. You know T.Y. put me on that shit.
Oh, yeah.
That motherfucker Deleon smooth as hell.
He's a liquor connoisseur.
The connoisseur. You don't want no libation? What is a libation?
The libation.
you ain't getting involved with no libation? Ooh, shit.
Made that
I should have got some water. Hmm? We got some music.
Did you mean to have your tag on? That's what you doing?
Oh, my God. I did not.
I thought it was part of the swag.
Just stuff it in. I'm just going to tuck mine in.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Just checking.
Ooh. I like the way you kiss me. We got a DJ? Yeah, yeah. You kiss me when we're playing the kissing game. Ooh, ow. All right,
well, I'm going to play a song in about 15 seconds.
Oh, shit. That means we hot.
We hot. Somebody.
Y'all gonna somebody, to
somebody top is gonna go surprise me. I don't even know what we're talking about.
I don't either.
Let's do it.
They're gonna sing a song.
I don't either.
Yeah, they're gonna sing the song.
It's a freestyle episode.
You want to do the theme song?
I don't know it that well.
Oh!
You just go. I hear the music. What's on your mind? That's what they told me.
Steve, you know what the music means.
Okay.
It's that time, baby. Welcome to the ballroom. Welcome to the ballroom. Ow. Y'all know what time it is. You can do what you want. In the ballroom.
Okay.
We talk a little bit. Sean.
If you really want to talk your shit, you can talk your shit. You can talk your shit.
Yeah. We talk shit tonight in the ballroom. Live stream every Friday night right here at 10 p.m. Live from the Artist Playground. Y'all know what time it is. I'm your boy, DJ Ball. I got a cast and crew here tonight.
Yes, sir.
Ow.
Let's get it.
Ballroom, baby. We keep it funky. You know what I'm saying? Welcome, Steph.
Hey.
First episode.
Yeah.
Got a new face. What's your name? Where you from? Tell the people
so,
about you.
I am Chef Steph.
Chef Steph.
On the streets.
Mm-hmm.
And Stephen in the sheets.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And okay. No, I'm just but yeah. So Chef Steph,
mm-hmm.
I have a culinary business teaching kids about international dishes around the world.
Okay.
And I have 4 kids, husband.
The whole nine.
Working mom, businesswoman, that kind of thing.
We love it. We love to hear you. Hey, I've known you for quite a while.
Yes, you have.
I've known you for quite a while. We're gonna have a good conversation this evening.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Okay. What's your what's the social handle? What can they find the food business?
So you can find me at Cooking Around the World.
Cooking Around the World. Mm-hmm. All one word?
All one word.
All right now. How you get that name? You had to pay for that domain?
Don't worry about it.
I mean, I asked too many questions, Chief.
Yeah.
What's up, Boogie?
What's up, bro?
Man, clean.
You know, I'm about that life. Man, ooh. Man, you know how we do, man.
Board of health.
One day at a time, man. Gotta keep it one day at a time, man. Had to come up by the sweatpants this week.
Man.
Come by the sweatpants this week.
Well, it looks good on you. You know what time it is. Ray.
You guys are so corny.
What's happening?
You guys are so corny.
What's happening, G?
Yo, what's up?
Man, nothing. Welcome back.
Thank you.
To the ballroom. You got a nice little gown on. You coming from somewhere?
Skims.
I ain't familiar. Good. I've heard of them. That's fancy. Is it fancy?
A little fancy.
Okay, feels that's what the young people say. It feel good on your Skims. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You coming from somewhere?
So I just came from the Lafayette Hotel.
Oh,
as you know,
I wanna go there.
They just completed all their renovations. Mm. It's so nice in there. Mm. So nice. Mm. So they got this drink called the Old Cuban.
Okay.
I never had that a day in my life. It's fire.
Okay.
Rum.
How many did you have?
Champagne. One.
Okay. Make sure you still with us.
How many did you have?
Yes.
Man, we appreciate you pulling up tonight. I got to check out the Lafayette. I keep hearing things.
It's really nice
I've heard
in there.
Things. You know what I mean? Put me a little sweater. I'm putting me a shirt on.
They got a DJ and everything.
I like it. Sure. Big Dog, what's happening, man? Welcome back, man. Stephen Anthony
boss?
In the building, man.
What's up, boss?
Man, how's the album?
What's
your name? Where you from? Talk to the people.
Stephen
real quick.
Anthony, the one and only.
Mm-hmm.
I just dropped the album. What was that last month?
Yes, sir.
I'm losing track of time, bro.
Yes, sir. It did fly by, no cap.
Yeah, that whole thing was a month ago.
It was.
It was 2 months ago.
Damn.
Mm-hmm. I know, right?
Yeah.
But yeah, man, life good. You know, chilling.
When was the last time you was here?
The day before the album, before the show.
I know. That's what I was thinking.
It was like almost a month.
The day before the show.
Yep.
Yeah, man, we performed live on that night. We was on stage doing some things. You know what I'm saying?
You said it was your first time.
It was my first time.
It didn't look like it.
Well, you know what I do. You know what I'm saying? I ain't scared of nothing, so I wasn't nervous. I don't think I moved enough. I don't know. I never know what to do with my hands. What do you do with your hands when you perform?
I don't know.
What am I supposed to do with all of this?
I just know. finally, the DM stopped coming in. Talking about, hey, who's your boy?
Oh, wait, don't worry about that, you know.
I'm like, hey,
comes with the tag.
He's tagged, nigga.
He's tagged.
Click on the tag.
You know, I keep it to myself. You know what I'm saying? Try not to do too much. But I enjoyed it, man. How the album do? How you feeling about the album?
Oh, man.
Everybody getting good feedback?
I'm ready. Yeah, I'm already back in the lab.
So okay. On the next already week. Ready to work?
Well, working, and then, you know, we about to drop
the collab app?
Yeah. That's about to be fire.
Don't tell them too much. Yeah. Give them a little sample. Give y'all a sample. You know what I'm saying? We finna do one of them Best of Both Worlds. Remember R. Kelly and Jay-Z?
Yep.
Nah, them two names we can't.
What?
We'll talk about them later.
Well, man. Let's do it, man.
We're going to talk about them later. Hey, real quick, though, I want to give a shout-out to my brother, Terrell. My brother's in the building. My sister, Tasha's in the building. Shout-out to Tara. Shout-out to Reese. We got the fam in the building. It's family time, man. So we're going to talk about family tonight a little bit. Oh, you got to add the camera over there? Ooh. Did y'all know y'all had a camera?
Y'all on camera.
In the background, singing in the background. Little Reese. Reese, you supposed to be in the seat over there. So we talking about family time tonight, man. One thing I want to say. Oh, wait, real quick. Let me bring this up real quick. I want to bring up this meme I seen. This made me think of it right here. It said, can we normalize having people over to play cards, drink, cook, please? No, not clubbing. Funny thing is, that's what we did last night. All we did was cook. We played some cards. You know, old niggas like to play some cards, man. We had some drinks. And it was just, it's a vibe. You know what I'm saying?
Kickback.
Terrell was talking all shit to y'all yesterday,
man,
too.
Man, that nigga was beating the bricks.
He was talking cash shit. Listen,
beat the sleeves off my ass in some spades. Yeah. I ain't playing no spades, man. I blame San Diego for the ass whoopings. Because I don't be making mistakes in no spades. I will, dog, you make a mistake playing with me, I'll be heated for
years.
Were
you reneging all night?
No, I didn't renege. I don't make them kind of mistakes. But I was doing shit like playing off, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'll play a queen when I'm supposed to play the king. My daddy like, don't do that. You know, my daddy.
Yeah.
He on my ass. He like, man, I thought you had something. I'm like, yeah, you right. I'm tripping. I'm tripping, bruh. Yeah, got that ass whooped last night. Got humbled up, baby, in some spades. But it was a time. Like I said, I enjoy family time. My question to y'all is, do y'all think that the concept of family is kind of fading? Because growing up, I swear to God, you had Big Mama house. You always had somewhere to go for Christmas and stuff like that. We don't even really celebrate stuff like that the same. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Y'all always have provided a safe space for events such as Thanksgiving, Christmas, things like that. But do y'all see the family dynamic kind of going away? And how? What do y'all take? What is y'all take on like the family and where we are right now?
Well, for me, I deal with children that are not in a family environment when it comes to eating.
Explain what you mean.
Okay, so they eat in front of the TV in front of their video games or, you know, phone, tablet, that kind of stuff. For and they have a faster lifestyle where they're not cooking dinner and stuff like that. So you don't have the Big Mama house that's cooking the dinner and the meals on Sundays or any day for that matter for a lot of those children. So I see a big decline in family meetings and family gatherings because food is not prepared.
You think it's the food? You think food has a lot to do with it?
I do.
And I think that's a really good observation because I agree with you 100%.
Because if you have food, people will come.
You ain't lying about that.
You know, and that's what I kind of hold on to, making sure that I keep good meals and food and stuff plentiful because I want people at my crib. I love to have and entertain and just see people. And then I go into my little corner or whatever, but, you know, I want to have that family gathering.
It's a balance. And there's so many people that take pride in being alone. You ever notice that now?
Yeah.
Like people be like, I like being by myself. I don't like nobody in my space and da 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 da. I'm like,
I'm kind of guilty.
But it's okay sometimes. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's okay sometimes. But if you selfish all your life, ain't nobody coming to your funeral. Yeah. You want an empty funeral? You feel what I'm saying? Like, life is about experience and experiencing people and loving and sharing and shit like that. Like, the mark you leave on this motherfucker. And you can't do that if you by yourself all the time, cooped up, trying to stay away from people because you're scared of getting hurt, or you scared of people crossing you, or you scared of people bringing down your energy and your vibe. Like, stop using energy and vibe as an excuse to just be an asshole. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't like people. That's okay. Just say that.
It's not even they don't even like people. They're just socially awkward now.
A lot of people are socially awkward. Why do you think that is, though? Because that's got a lot to do with the family.
Well, you got a social awkward, so I agree with the food thing. Mm-hmm. But I'm going to go ahead and keep it real.
Uh-huh.
The big mama 37 years old. Let's talk about that. Big Mama don't know how to fucking cook. She 37 years old. She been popping that kitty. She been popping that kitty in the club. She came home. She too tired to cook.
From twerking.
She been twerking the whole game.
It was just about time.
How long did it take? Like 5 minutes?
We about five minutes in. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. I'm gonna keep it real. That's just what it is.
Big Mama exhausted.
Big Mama 37 years old and twerking in the club.
Popping. She hung over.
She hung over.
She can't cook on Sunday.
She can't cook. That's just what, mean, that's why it's going away.
I mean, grandma is not giving out them recipes anymore.
She ain't got no recipe.
She's not giving out the recipe.
Who got the recipe?
Who got the recipe?
Who got the recipes, man?
Nobody. For me, mm-hmm. you know.
Did you get passed down?
No.
Oh, wow.
I had to watch my mom cook. Mm. That's how I learned. If okay. you wanted to me learn too. How to cook, you had to be in the kitchen. Mm-hmm. And if you wasn't in the kitchen, then you wasn't in the kitchen. Mm. You can't be yeah. in the kitchen.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know? So I just feel like, was it millennials? Millennials end at 96, right?
I think I'm a millennial, ain't I?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm the era of like us learning and us like having those experiences just don't, it's just not there anymore.
Yeah.
Look at the generations. Like when everything is instant, mm-hmm. instant gratification, yep. instant meals, like instant everything, you know? So that's just my take on it.
So yeah. no family because we instant. People making their own families, bro. You see this? This is a military town. You from San Diego?
Yeah.
So you see this in the military towns. Like we come here and we make our families. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like you away from your family for so long and shit. That distance at some point, you don't even know who the fuck people are no more. You know what I mean? But when you're here and you got military brothers and military sisters and everything like that, people go through hell together. And then the things they go to, like military people won't tell you what they go through together sometimes because they can't sometimes, but sometimes it's just, it's too much. You know what I'm saying? But like the experiences that we share together, something that some families never get a chance to do. So the bonding is different. So I noticed in San Diego, a lot of people make their families. That's why Friendsgiving is so big out here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Friendsgiving bigger than Thanksgiving.
Huge.
When you think about it. But you a family man. Yeah. How you think the state of families are?
Nah, I agree. It starts with the food.
Mm.
The other thing I was going to say, too, is that a lot of families is losing, like, that love that they have for each other.
Because
mm. It's like a lot. First of all, a lot of people got their own lives. You know, shit's going
personal
on.
Personal lives. Yeah.
So it goes back to, like, I feel like there's not enough love within the family because it's usually, like, I'm seeing cliques within the families, too.
Mm-hmm.
I only rock with this side and these mm-hmm. these many people. So
yeah.
And when they don't like to come together because certain people don't, you know, rock with that. But, like, it alludes back to what you said, like, with the big mama.
Big mama.
You know, she didn't play that. She mm-hmm. didn't play that shit. At least how I was growing up, my grandma didn't play that shit. It was like, it don't matter if you don't like this person, yeah. y'all still got to come together. And we will have a good time. So I just think it's with the food, definitely the food. A lot of people don't know how to cook. I can't lie.
They don't, man.
I used to know how to cook like four dishes.
Mm.
And because I got lazy.
Mm. My That's okay to say that.
Yeah, I got lazy. So mm-hmm. I forgot. I don't know how to make nothing no more. So I'm part of the blame too.
Yeah.
Because that kind of leaks onto my kids. Like I can't teach them nothing. Luckily, my wife know how to cook, but. Even within my own family, I only see the same set of people during holidays, and the rest of my family
they clicked
up. We cool, yeah, but it's that
like
click.
You said, yeah.
It's not the same love no more.
Favorite cousin,
and then once grandma died, you know,
yeah, she was holding all like together, that. Man. Yeah.
So, unfortunately, I have no grandparents left. Okay, but in my family, personally, I can remember my aunties was like the gatekeepers. Even now, my auntie is like, when I'm home and I'm in St. Louis and it's a holiday, I already know who house we going to. You know what I'm saying? Now, my granddaddy got 22 kids. So our family dynamic is a little different because there's a lot of us. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I remember one 4th of July. TJ, I don't know if you remember this. 4th of July, we played softball at, it's a park off like, goddamn. It's by Deborah House, huh? Spanish Lake. I think it was Spanish Lake. We played softball, and it looked like a softball game. You know what I'm saying?
All family.
Yeah.
All family. And it's 11 on 11, nigga. It's going down. You know
That's
what I'm
huge.
Saying? And we got a very, very competitive family. You know what I'm saying? So, like, my family dynamic is a lot different from what I see in other families. Yeah. But even in my family, I'm noticing, like, I go home less now. You know what I'm saying? Like, when I'm home, it ain't never, like, no love. It ain't never like, hey, how you doing? It's like, hey. It's like... You know what I'm saying? Like you said, so people so consumed with their own lives and shit like that.
Maybe because they feel like they saw you on Instagram just a second ago.
Some of them didn't. Yeah. You know what I mean? But I see what you're saying about that, too. I think that we do have that microwave because I got a lot of cousins. We just share memes. That's all we do.
Yeah.
We just share memes back and forth. Man, you seen this? You know, yeah. It's just... So we do keep in contact that way, too. But yeah, I want to talk about social media and family as well. Now, Facebook seems to be the place for the older... variety,
yeah.
Your aunties and uncles and shit.
Yeah.
I seen your son. People call my mom. I seen him cussing on that Facebook. I be like, oh god.
Well,
that Facebook.
40-year-olds are still on Facebook.
It's true.
A lot. Yeah. A lot of moms.
Me.
I still put out marketing on Facebook.
Facebook works.
It works.
Ain't nothing wrong with no Facebook now.
And it's a lot of moms.
I think Facebook is for family.
Yeah.
Yeah. Instagram is not for family.
No.
Snapchat is not for none of that.
You know what's funny is that every time I share something on IG, you know how it has that... Share Facebook.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I always, depending on what I'm posting, nine times out of ten, I'm always clicking no.
I swear to God.
You gotta separate that shit.
Fuck that. Like, yeah. I don't want to hear it. That's why.
Yeah.
Because what you just said, oh, you, your son rapping, he got that song.
He rapping.
He talking about
sucking titties.
Yeah.
I'm like, fuck that.
Nope. Everybody, me mom is on Facebook.
Yeah, oh,
Facebook.
God. But if my mama watching, I love you. She said, I've tried to watch. Y'all be doing all that cussing. I said, Mama, it's late night. It's 1 o'clock in the morning in St. Louis right now.
What are you doing up?
Go to bed. You know what I'm saying? How do y'all feel about, because what I've seen a statistic that said there's more active fathers now than ever before.
Mm-hmm.
And I can tell you the truth, like, I believe it.
Yeah.
I look around. I look at my partners. All my partners is dads. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody like, man, I don't fuck with my baby. I don't fuck with my kids. Who says that? You know what I'm saying? I think our generation is much better off than the last. What do y'all see the state of parenthood right now in family?
We have improved as the fathers and stuff. A lot of, like I said, we're in our kids' lives.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I see them. I see a lot of dads and stuff when I go to school to pick the kids up,
mm-hmm.
whatever, stuff like that. So I think it's gotten better.
Yeah. I remember going to Q's games. And I would go to Q's football games, and me and the dads
be kicking it.
You know what I'm saying?
Kicking it
at the games. And in my mind, I don't never remember that.
Yeah.
I just don't. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my daddy. My daddy, man, that's my OG. He in town right now. My daddy came to a couple of my games. You know what I'm saying? But I don't ever remember the daddies like conversing like that, being cool. You was raised by your dad?
Yeah.
Yeah, me and TJ.
My dad was
TJ.
A single dad.
We was raised by dad. I said we was raised by dad.
Yes.
He did his thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. How was it a girl being raised by a dad?
It was cool. Cool as shit. Like,
he was like Brianna and Flex. One on one.
Anything. My ride or die. He's still my ride or die.
Do you feel like that molded you to be a wife? Because.
Yeah, I think he definitely structured me to be a wife. I remember always wanting to be a wife.
Mm.
Always playing Barbie or with Ninja Turtles. I don't know why, but I didn't have any
incest.
Kin.
No,
my dad didn't want me to have no kin, so I had Ninja Turtles.
Okay.
And
Raphael's my name.
Yeah, and I always pretended like the whole marriage and the whole, that was just me.
I think that's bestiality, right? No?
Oh, no.
Ninja Turtles?
Yeah, Barbie. Yeah, Barbie and a Ninja Turtle?
No, because you can't fuck a turtle, right?
Oh, turtle can fuck you.
Their penises spawn out.
Oh,
like
so
this.
You doing the business.
Yeah, you're doing
the business. Their penises spawn out.
It's like a flat.
This. Yeah, it's spawn.
How do y'all know about turtle dicks? Am I new?
We've seen tortoise.
You go to the zoo. San Diego Zoo.
Tortoises hump.
Uh-huh.
And they
every
moan.
Time.
Every time. And they moan.
And they moan.
Are they the ones that, when they done, they
that's
fall,
wild.
They fall back.
That's wild.
Yeah, they be on the top of their shell.
I've seen that shit.
I don't want no coochie make me fall out my shell.
Fall out the shell.
Imagine you at the zoo and you see some turtles see doing it. You're hearing, oh yeah, fuck y'all. You're like, what the fuck? What that turtle say?
A turtle fall out the shell, that shit fire.
That shit fire.
That shit must be fire.
I don't want none of that.
That's nasty.
So when it comes to family, we talking about family, right? I noticed that I have this topic that I want to talk about. I want to call it kid shaming. Y'all know where I'm going?
Oh, yeah.
Y'all know where I'm going with this?
I'm not a fan of that.
Yeah.
It's like when people tell you that you have kids, or somebody say, how many kids you got? Oh, I got three. You be like, damn, you got three kids? Oh, you got two? Oh, damn, you got two kids? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a lot of kids and shit. And then now you're not valued anymore. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, they say, oh, you're not a high-value woman, or you're not a high-value man if you have children. But what if you're an amazing parent?
And you're providing for those kids.
Yeah.
Then what? What's y'all take on this child-shaming thing? Mm. Rachel? You're not a fan.
Well, I'm not a fan.
Have you had men tell you, I would date you, but you got a kid?
Absolutely not.
Okay.
Absolutely not.
See, I don't got that problem.
No, not at all.
Stepdaddies.
Yeah, I'm not. That's what they want to be.
Right.
They'll never be that. so I guess my issue is not people saying like, oh, you have too many kids. Mm-hmm. It's them being on social media and like dogging their kids on social media. So there's like a bunch of TikToks and reels out there where parents would do this like thing where they kind of do like this selfie, and they're like, I should have swallowed you instead of like having you, or, you know, like
that's derogatory. That's diabolical.
Derogatory. Word. Like, you see, now my daughter's 18 and now she dresses like this. Like, you know, like I don't like that.
What is on your Instagram?
I see a lot of things. Like, I'm on Instagram, Twitter. It gets really wild from like what people send me, and so you know the algorithm changes when people send you things and you share things.
Like turtle sex.
I'm gonna send that to you.
I don't know if I'm in the mood for turtle porn tonight.
No, but like I just find it so interesting to see that stuff, you know, because it's like, this is what we live in now. This is the world that we live in. We live in shaming.
Do you think
everybody.
Bad parenting is normal now? Because it feels like it is. Because when you see a good parent, you be like, oh, okay, you're doing your fucking thing.
What
you know
is
what
a
I'm
bad
saying?
Parent, though?
I think a bad parent is somebody who allows their child to absolutely be a menace to society. Like, if you could see your child going towards a path of being someone who doesn't produce anything to society and you don't do anything to change it, I think you could be considered a bad parent.
See, for me, it's more of neglect.
Because you can be there every day and raise a monster.
That's what I'm trying to say.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm more of calling somebody a bad parent if they neglect their child.
Okay.
If they emotionally
neglect
or, you know, with communication, they're always on their phone, they're always watching TV or too busy or, you know, I see that a lot. And that there, to me, is a bad parent.
I understand.
Now, if you're raising a menace to society, sometimes they're born that way.
You think they born demons?
I have four children.
And they all different.
And they're all different.
I understand.
And I raised them the same. I swear to God, I try to raise them the same.
I understand.
And some of them are just, I just pray for them. The world.
Pray for the world?
Yeah. You know?
Unleash them into the world.
I gotta agree with that. See, okay, growing up, I have a trans brother, right?
Okay.
And my mom used to say, you know, you guys, I can't treat you guys the same because you guys are not the same.
Mm.
And I was like, what? What does that even mean? Like, you know, you don't do the things that I want you to do for me, but you do it for her. But I don't get that.
Mm-hmm.
And it all made sense. Totally different person.
Totally different.
Like, you know, so that was one of the things that used to irk me growing up as a kid. Like, I can't raise you guys the same because you guys are not the same.
I think as a child, we don't understand that being treated differently is not the same as being loved differently.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you can love us all the same, but you know that I respond to something a certain kind of way. And you know TJ might respond to something a certain type of way. You know what I mean? Like, you have to raise your children accordingly.
According to their personalities.
Yeah. Some asses need to be tapped on.
Yeah. Some do not. And some, you just say something and they just bust out crying.
Because they some marks. You know what I'm saying? Punk ass kids.
You lost all my stories.
Oh, no, I mean, sorry, Niecy. you call my baby a mark. Nah, but I'm just saying, like, I feel like with the family dynamic, we don't force family on our children either. You ever noticed that?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I when we was coming up, you had to go. Like, if it was something going on, you had to go to that
you
shit.
You had to go to that shit.
You know what I'm saying?
You had to. Church. It wasn't a choice.
Church, right. Church. You had to go to
that. Family vacation, if you had that.
If you had that, right?
Yeah. You know, and I was blessed to have that. And as a matter of fact, I just got back in from Miami from someone else's, my best friend's family vacation.
Okay. Shout out to Jackie.
Yeah, shout out Jackie.
Mm-hmm.
And she took us on this amazing resort and everything, and I saw a lot of families vacationing.
Beautiful. Beautiful. I never... Did y'all ever grow... Let me ask y'all a question. Did y'all ever go on a family vacation?
No.
I did.
It wasn't...
I don't remember one.
It wasn't deemed a family vacation. It was like, we just get in the car, drive, where the fuck we end up. That's...
I think that's a nigga vacation. Can I tell you what I thought about? I think that's a nigga vacation.
Cousin's house in Virginia. Crooklyn.
Taking a road trip down to Louisiana.
Yeah.
All right. Family reunion down here. We're going to get a hotel room, go get some Roberto Chillings and some Stacey Adams for the weekend.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? We might got to go to church.
That was a family vacation.
That was vacations. And it was used in the summertime. Yeah. That's nigga vacation. That was fancy. I don't ever remember getting on no plane, no cruises. Nope. I don't ever remember doing that. But nowadays, I see that a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Like a whole lot. Maybe that's one of the reasons for the divide. When you think about it. Because now, like you said, families are clicked up. So if you just take it only your immediate family, you ain't going to the family union no more. You know what I'm saying?
No, you're going with your unit.
You're going with your unit. And the friend and your friends.
And your friends.
Exactly.
And your circle.
I am not about to pay for cousin number one, auntie number two. I'm not paying for none of them. Mm-mm. They got it. And if they don't got it, I'm going with my, you know, I'm going with my people.
Mm. Let me ask y'all individually, when was the last time y'all been to a family reunion?
You don't set them up no more.
No.
Yeah. It's supposed to be our responsibility.
You know what I was finna say? You know whose fucking fault that is?
It's our fault.
It's ours.
We're supposed to set that shit up.
It's ours. Because when you think about it, it's our turn.
Yeah, it's our turn. Yeah.
Yep. Who planning a family reunion?
Every funeral.
TT, she can't even remember your damn name. Yeah.
Every funeral is a family reunion.
Ooh, the funerals are deep. Now.
Yeah.
That's deep. Damn, that sounded sad too.
Mine was January the 11th. I'll never forget it. Well, January 11th, 2023. That's when my grandma was buried.
23.
Mm-hmm. And that was the last time we had a family, like, huge gathering. Yeah.
I hate that it's usually, because I'm from St. Louis, so it happens a lot. You know what I mean? It's usually a funeral.
It's usually a funeral.
And I'm going home for funerals. I don't want to go home for that. Yeah. Now, I've been home for graduations. That's my jam right there. I'll go for a graduation now.
Yeah, that's
graduations are always a sign of growth in the family. You know what I'm saying? A birth of a child or something like that. Like, I love graduations.
Yeah.
But I did notice that weddings as well. Shout out to my sister Rachel. She's getting married tomorrow.
Hey,
so we got family in town. The family's in town for the wedding tomorrow. Look, they keep getting some camera time. Look. Family's in town for the wedding tomorrow. We're going to have a really good time tomorrow, man. We had a family dinner tonight. It was a lot of fun. But weddings, funerals, and stuff like that, that's usually the only time nowadays, which is, like I said, we got to do better.
Yeah.
Have to do better. You know what I'm saying?
Well, how do you think we can do better in a society that's different, that's shaped different, where gatherings like that don't really happen? How are you going to be the forefrunter in that?
Because I think they don't happen because of us.
I got to agree with that. We're not traditional anymore.
No.
We don't live in a traditional
society. It's shaped different. But, like, you got to have, like, a virtual reunion.
Can I ask y'all a question?
I think we lazy as fuck. It's a lot. Go ahead.
I like that you use the word. You know what? You said something. You said something to me that woke me the fuck up, bro. And I've been woke since then. I was feeling depressed, right? I mean, we had this conversation. Oh, yeah. I was feeling super depressed. I didn't get up. I didn't clean my house. I wasn't cooking. I was gaining weight. I wasn't working out. And I was like, bro, I think I'm depressed. And you said right in my face and said, nigga, you ain't depressed. You just lazy.
Oof.
And I snapped out of that shit just like this. I said, you ain't even lying. Because I still have the ability to get up. Mentally, I'm down. But physically, these legs still work. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Just move these motherfuckers. And then this is
start moving again.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And when you said that, I said, damn, boy.
Yeah.
Thank you. And that's why you need friends like that. You know what I'm saying?
Especially when you can pinpoint all of the stuff that you need to do. You got a list of stuff. You got a list of the goals. You don't know what you need to do.
Right.
I get to start moving.
I think depression is an excuse sometimes. We use these We give ourselves a disease that we might not even fucking have. You know what I'm saying?
Self-diagnosis.
Anxiety, right.
One of them.
But everybody got anxiety.
Yeah.
Everybody has anxiety.
Everybody experiences anxiety.
Yeah.
But do you have a chronic anxiety where you experience
severe.
It severely?
Yeah.
Is the definition of
somebody
having
hug you and you break
anxiety.
Out in hives. Shit. Yeah.
That's what it is when you talk about the, like the have family reunion stuff. Like I said, we just fucking lazy.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's not like we're not out of touch. What I'm saying is we're not out of touch. I'm saying we're not out of touch. You like we like I said, we share memes, Facebook, all the stuff. We with everybody.
Yeah.
It don't take much. All you gotta do is say, hey, 8 months from now, let's meet at this place at this time, and we're gonna stay for this amount of time.
Okay.
That's all you gotta do. And that's how you bring everybody together. It's easy. But they choose not to.
You ever try to get 30 niggas
exactly.
on the trip?
Exactly. But because you on Instagram, I saw that chain you just bought.
Mm-hmm.
I saw them $800 pair of Jordans that you fucking bought.
You're right.
Your tax money just came in this month.
Oh, that tax money gonna hit.
Oh, I know you can pay for a trip to get where we going,
that.
But they don't care about
don't
that.
Don't be counting my money.
They don't care about that.
Nobody gives a fuck about that. Let's just be real.
You're right. Don't nobody care.
No, I don't care what you got. Like, all I know is that if you can pay for me to go, I'm there. If you are providing food, I am there. If you provide in the smokes, the drinks. Like, I'm there.
I like how you got that smoke.
You know what I mean?
Yes, ma'am.
But, like, that's what people live off of. Mm-hmm. Instant. It's free. I can get there. You paying for me? Cool.
Facts.
But that's a problem, though. Like, you can't, like, pay for this. Like, for somebody to pay. Just meet there. You with family. Why not just put what happened to the potlucks?
Right.
What happened to the potluck? Like, if you show up at your homeboy house and you'd have bought him an $80 bottle.
Yeah.
Oh, so you bought something to the house to go play cards.
Yeah.
But you can't put up. But you can't put up with what you call it.
But you know what? That comes down to this too. Some families. Oh, we had a young lady on the show last week. She was Jewish, and she was able to do her
birthright.
Her birthright.
It's a birthright.
And Marissa was her, and she asked her, like, you know, who pays for that? She said, oh, they have a pot already. Yeah. They pay for it. Right?
Yeah.
So with a family, as far as example, for family big as mine, we used to have dues. I don't know if you remember that.
Yep,
but I remember we had dues.
Daddy
had
dues. Yet, I'm not capping. Ask
daddy.
Interest.
They used to have dues,
it
right? Family dues.
Yeah.
And you had to pay $50 a month or something like that. And everybody put into a pot. Yep. And it would pay for
the family reunion,
the shirts, and the travel, and the rooms. It would go to his rooms, and it would go to his family events, like booking the parks and stuff like that. I think that's the stuff we're now supposed to be organized, and we're not doing it because we don't really care about our family.
I'm not going to do that.
Do y'all care about your family?
I cannot trust people. I don't trust people for that. Mm-hmm. I don't trust people like taking my money and putting it up into a bank account, and then next thing you know, they steal the money.
It's your family.
Like, I don't give a damn. Like, somebody's legs is really going to get. You know, allegedly
broken.
Broken. You know, I don't play that.
Yeah.
I put $50 in this pot every month, right? That's like...
And then they say we're not going.
And now we go to the family reunion, it's chili dogs.
Girl. Nah, they
bitch.
Say no family reunion.
Bitch, if y'all get some Cornish hens in this bitch, girl, I done put $68. No, but I've been thinking lately, for real, because I'm getting to that age where you start thinking, and you be like, damn, we ain't gonna be here that much longer. You know
but
what I'm saying?
But do you really want to be the sole gatherer of your family? Like,
not
that's
solely.
That's a huge responsibility.
It's a big-ass family.
You know, do you really want to be the unk?
The unk.
You know what I mean?
Uncle Ball.
Yeah, like, that's a huge responsibility.
I get
and
it.
In today's time, that's like roping cattle.
To organize now is a lot different because I think the standards have changed. Because again, when we was coming up, family reunion was at a park.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You book a park. You get some t-shirts and you had your ass there. You ain't even had real sodas, nigga. It wasn't Pepsi.
It's RC Cola.
It was cola. It's Shasta's. Mm-hmm. You better get you some of this Mountain Freeze and be good. You know what I'm saying? We ain't even had real sodas, real snacks, real food. But we made it work and it worked.
And you had fun as a family.
But nowadays, people go on lavish vacations by themselves. If you just came back from Jamaica, nigga, you don't want to go to Louisiana for a trip.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers got in their head that they celebrities and they superstars.
Well, that's what y'all was talking about last time about not enjoying America.
Yeah. Traveling here,
learning to experience where you live.
Yeah.
You know, and I thought that was very interesting. Mm-hmm. Like, because for me... You know, I do want to go to overseas, but more.
Mm-hmm.
But I've learned to appreciate where I am and hopping around and seeing beautiful states. I really like that.
It's a lot here. And the funny part about America is, depending on the region, you could feel like you're in a different country for sure.
Yeah,
you
for
can.
Sure,
like
for
each
sure.
State, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I want to talk to the West Coast brother real quick, man. I feel like on the West Coast is the most disconnect I've seen a family. Like, I don't really see a lot of family gatherings out here.
Yeah.
Like, just people getting together, like, you know what I'm saying? Just on humbug, you know what I mean? When I'm in St. Louis, I ain't gonna lie to you. Somebody be like, hey, man, we playing cards tonight. You might get a basement full of niggas, you know what I'm saying? I'm just keeping it a bean, you know what I mean? Like, people like that because in St. Louis, a lot of times, no, I'm not trying to be funny, but you go out, you might not make it home, you know what I'm saying? So it's safer a lot of times to go to somebody's house and just play cards, and you can get fucked up with your people. You feel like you're in a safe space, you know what I mean? So St. Louis, Chicago, places like that, like, people have house parties still. Yeah. I don't see no house parties out here. What's the deal out here in San Diego, man?
It's a lot of factors. I mean, first of all, we ain't got the culture like, you know, like they do in the South.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Different,
that's
different
okay.
areas of the country.
You know what I'm saying?
But it's just like, depending on where, first of all, a lot of people that live here, they not from here, first of all.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I think just because, like, even parts of my family is not from here.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, there's, like I mentioned with the cliques, they'll get together because they grew up that way. And because, like, I've heard excuses like, there's too much shit going on. It's about individuality. Mm. So we're not going to get together. Or you hear, like, when we try to plan parties or just, like, come through for a kickback.
Yeah.
Who all going to be there? I mean, I know that's
who all going to be there. That's the word. That's
all. Who all going to be there? Or, I'll see, you know. And then once you start getting those kind of messages, we just be like, fuck it. Ain't no point in trying to get together like that. Unless it's on a holiday or some shit like that. Or a funeral. Those are the only times we ever kind of see each other. So I always used to say with family, certain parts with families, it's like, speaking of like on Instagram or social media, you fuck with me on Instagram, but you don't fuck with me in real life.
In real life. Mm-hmm. So, when you see me out, it's weird.
It's like, I fuck with you, but I don't fuck with you like that. Like, I can't like really be around you like that. Mm-hmm. But like what you said earlier too, like, You'll bring an $80 bottle to your homeboy house or some shit like that. But when it's family,
you won't
even give $10-$15 to something
because you don't know them like that.
Yeah, it's exactly.
That's weird.
So
that's weird.
That's your bloodline, man. Your bloodline should matter at some point.
So out here, I mean, growing up when I was a teenager, man, there was a couple of house parties still. Not really here in the city. But I mean, I guess once it was just a shift.
Yeah, I get it.
I don't know what it was. Maybe when social media started getting popping off like that, but people just stopped doing shit. It really is just the club. If you ain't in the club, you really ain't kicking it.
I can say after COVID.
Yeah.
Like before, when COVID hit, now people are really not, like, COVID warped some people's minds during that time.
I think more than we realize.
Yeah. And I think people are still trying to come out of that shell. They're still battling with social anxiety and depression and everything from that time.
I agree 100%. I thought about something one day when I seen a meme or something, and it was just like, hold on. Somebody said, oh, what's up, Ashley? Yep. Ashley said, it is. I've tried it, and some family is stubborn and still holding on to grudges. Ain't no cap. I got shout out to my auntie Pauline. Pauline got mad at me one time at the family reunion when we was kids. I ain't forgave Pauline yet.
Granddad.
Robin either. I love y'all. But we hold grudges. I was just telling Terrell about Tyron. I got a cousin that wrecked a car. He wrecked my expedition. This is a true story. He was in St. Louis and he took my car while I was sleeping and he hit a school bus with children on it. Oh. Brought me my car back and said somebody, it was a hit and run. I drove the car to get it fixed. I got pulled over by the police, snatched me and my partner Brian, got snatched out the car, threw on the car, the motherfuckers roughed us up and everything. Like, what we do? Y'all know what the fuck y'all did. Took us to jail. We went to jail for hitting a school bus with children on it. They got him in there, and he confessed and the whole shit like that, but we ended up getting let go the same day, but at the same time, I never forgave that motherfucker, because even when they brought him to the police station, he still was lying. He was going to let me go down for that shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't give a fuck what we bleed, my nigga. I don't fuck with you no more.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So sometimes those grudges can stay grudges.
Yeah.
And that's okay. You know what I'm saying? Depends on how far it went. You was going to let me burn, my nigga. So, no, we can't come back from that. Okay. Now, if you fuck my girlfriend or something in third grade, not third grade. That's nasty work. Like, you fuck my girlfriend in high school or something, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'd be like, okay, whatever. You know what I'm saying? I can get over some corny shit like that, but I'd never get over you trying to make me lose my freedom. You know what I'm saying?
So
those grudges do last. But I want to get back to my West Coast family over here. I noticed that what you were saying was kind of resonating with me when it come down to the priority of parties. I call it like party priority. People always got to let you know. Yeah. You know why? Because something more popping might pop up.
Yep.
Yeah, last minute.
You know what I'm saying? And I noticed that when I moved to the West Coast. That's why I told you my
we'll talk about that,
when I moved out here, I had to change my philosophy. My philosophy is now don't take it personal. Whenever people do something, I never take it personal, for real. I just want to see my name on the big screen. Hey, what's up, big dog? You up there. You on the big screen, man. Right. But I wanted to ask y'all about this. Do y'all notice that as being a trend out here? Like, it's like you have to go to the more pop-up. So say I have a party, and there's only 30 people at my party. But somebody else having a party, it's 130 people at their party.
Yeah. Pool party.
Pool party. Mm-hmm. People will tell you they coming, and then when something else more popping comes... They word don't mean a motherfucking thing.
Yeah.
Is that a West Coast thing or what? Third grade. T.Y., baby.
I think that's a people thing.
Yeah.
That's a people thing.
I think that's a people thing.
Okay, because where I'm from, you say you coming, motherfuckers coming. You know what I'm saying?
Because they count on your drink.
There you
okay.
go.
Okay, they count on like how much you gonna
there
eat.
You go.
I agree.
You know, they got you down packed. Okay, you bringing a friend?
Right, type shit.
You bringing a friend?
Type shit.
How many?
You bring a couple friends.
Who all gonna be? Who all gonna be there?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, let me see a picture of them.
Yeah.
Show me. Let's send me a picture.
So I agree, that's a people thing. But when I moved out here, I noticed that being a much more common thing, though.
It's what community you're in.
I'm in this black community. Because it's
6%. In the Hispanic community, because I got to
okay.
chill.
There we go. Let's talk.
And I'm talking about kickbacks every day, man. Every single day.
Yeah.
Filipino community.
Mm-hmm.
What else? I've been chilling with a lot of the Indian community lately.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, it's people all the time, and their family flies in from India and all kind of places.
They dedicate it
just to eat dinner with them and be around them. So I don't know if it's a West Coast, East Coast thing. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't say that.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's a black thing.
Damn.
I agree.
I agree too.
Let's talk about it.
I definitely agree.
Yeah.
I feel like people who are born and raised here in San Diego, they don't really want to experience San Diego the way that it's meant to be experienced, you know, because San Diego is a tourist town. You know, we're really known for our tuna and our beer.
Mm.
So it's most people don't even know that, you know, especially like Little Italy.
Mm.
Italy was known for that. But I think that once somebody tries to step out of their norm and try to do things, then they're deemed weird or they're deemed like, oh, you're just too good for us. Like, why? Because I don't want to be stuck in the same mentality as you. I don't want to be depressed all the time. I don't want to feel like everybody around here is just on some bullshit all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Well, no, it's really your community. You choose to stick with these same people, and these same people
with that same mind.
Right. Bring you down.
Yeah.
And I don't want to be around that. But also, in retrospect, like, you have to have the money. You have to have the stuff. You have to be somebody in order for you to have like a certain type of community with you that's really gonna fuck with you.
I noticed that.
Yeah.
Since I've been in San Diego.
Like,
as
if
well.
You're broke, if you don't have anything, like,
hang out with
not
the broke
gonna
people.
Fuck with
it's
you.
A status.
But they're not gonna fuck with you. Like,
you
and it's a real thing. Like, same thing with downtown. Downtown, PB, like, everywhere that you go here, and specifically in San Diego, like, if you don't got it and you don't got the people that actually have it too, you're nothing.
It's the people. Because I'm going to tell you something. I ain't no scrub, cuz if I come in this bitch, we going to have a good time. I'm going to have a good time. I'm going to spend some money. You know what I'm saying? But I go places. Don't nobody know me in this bitch. I'm not from this city. But I went downtown with you one time.
Mm-hmm.
And we was moving like what? Walking in clubs and shit. We walking in places. You know what I'm saying? I'm just like, what the fuck? Because you have to be, you have to know people here.
You have to.
You know what I'm saying?
People.
If you don't know people here or you ain't got no money, like money, I'm talking about money.
Status.
You really not going.
But we had a great time.
Always. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Me and Boogie do too when we
came. Oh, yeah.
No, this, you know, Rachel cool.
No, we budget.
We budget.
No, we 1,000.
We kicking
no,
on the budget. Yeah, see, Rachel get free shit, so it's.
Exactly.
I need to go with Rachel.
You need to go with Rachel.
Listen, I got you. Look.
But I don't want to talk bad about it, because I don't think it's necessarily a bad thing that people are so into themselves here. You know what I mean? And that's what I think it all boils down to. Wrapping up the whole family conversation, I think it all comes down to ourselves. Like, a lot of people are so consumed with their own happiness, with their own self-care, self-worth, self-everything. Like, when you talk to somebody now, it's all about self-something, which all leads back to selfish.
Yeah.
But they don't want to say it because it sounds fucked up. But it's truth. It's okay to be a little selfish.
It is okay.
You know what I mean? But I just noticed that the selfishness out here seems to be at a much different level.
I question you on that, though.
Talk to me.
Because when people are always talking about self-care, self-this, I feel as though it's because they need that. because of something that was lacking.
Okay.
And if we're in a state or era where everybody's saying we need self-care, it's because the generation before us lacked that need as much so that we are desperately in need of self-care.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think it's a bad thing right now. I think it's just a thing that will wave and go out, just like any other trend or fad.
Yeah.
And I believe it's definitely needed right now after the state of COVID. Like, you just can't forget that happened.
I think a lot of people are trying to, though.
And they were depressed. So what do you do when you're depressed? You're supposed to have self-care to take care of your depression. Agreed. So it's like all that big bubble from rappers or stuff talking about suicides during all that time. And then now is like every R&B song is self-care,
yeah, self-love, yeah, all that
you
shit.
You know, yeah. And they just came out with Bob Marley, One Love.
Yeah, yeah,
you know, right. So it's, to me, I think it's morally who you are.
I think what's happening with the self-care thing is people are abusing it, like with anything else.
Oh, yeah,
else.
It's like a trend.
They're abusing the word energy. They're abusing the word vibes. They're abusing these words that make sense and they can't be challenged, because how can you challenge something as a vibe?
That don't exist.
If I tell you that your vibe, hey, nigga, your vibe off, bro. I don't like the way you looking at me with your hands in your pocket, my nigga. How can you challenge that? You know what I'm saying?
Well, your aura, it's not for you.
I'm not for you.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like, I feel like a lot of people, self-centered. Somebody says self-centered. Exactly what it comes down to.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, but go speak. You can speak on. It's okay.
Like,
it's okay.
It's the villain.
Mm-hmm.
It's the era. It's villain era right now where people just don't care. Mm-hmm. Well, there was a. I was in New
York.
I'm
okay being the bad guy.
No. But it was on a shirt. Oh. A perfect example. This nigga was walking down the street in a shirt and it said, "I don't know. I don't care. Mm. I don't give a fuck."
I kind of like the shirt.
And I was with the shirt.
Yeah,
I was like, that makes perfect sense.
Yeah.
Because don't come over here with your bullshit.
I agree.
Don't try to make it seem like, you know, like I'm being manipulative and I'm the narcissist and I'm this bad guy. But in reality, you're just a dumbass.
Find
and I'm
to
telling
do, yeah.
you that you're a dumbass. Nobody wants to hear the truth anymore. And that's what kills me. Like, I feel like we're just in this soft era. You were talking about this the other day, like the soft boy.
Soft era.
The soft era,
yeah.
Where you can't tell anybody anything. You can't do anything with anybody because they're going to feel a type of way. Their energy is off. We're retrograde. Like, you know, that all has to tie in to nonsense, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I think, like you said, like it has to do with us having that time during the pandemic where we're like, what's astrology? How am I going to be a better person? Like,
I blame astrology for a lot of the behavior I hear.
You know,
well. Hey, shout out to Ashley. Ashley said, "I live to be the villain."
I'm
mad
saying.
At it. Thanos, I hear you, Thanos. Nino
Stop
Brown.
It.
Nino
I think it's
Brown,
too. I think it's
baby.
Just too easy, man.
What's that?
We create fucking problems, man.
We creating a lot of problems.
Like we talk, like I said, we talk about COVID and COVID one shit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They had the Black Plague, motherfucking. We built railroads and built up the whole goddamn city.
We made it.
We built up the whole city.
After the plague.
After the plague.
Yeah,
the Spanish-American War. After wars, we built in whole cities.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
You had 1 year where you had to stay in your fucking house and you couldn't eat out?
2 years.
It was 2 years.
Year and a half. Two years.
Yeah. But I
the
can tell you what.
The wars lasting decades.
It was literally something that happened to everybody as a mass, right? And truth be told, when the Black Plague was happening, they didn't have it on the news every day.
But people was dropping.
Scaring every fucking body. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
they was dropping like flies.
Like
now,
flies.
If there was Fox News when there was the Black Plague, it would have been way worse.
Yeah.
Way worse.
True.
But you got to think about the psychological damage that it did to humans on this continent right here.
This
when
era.
That shit was spread right in this era. Like
in
you
this
said,
era.
In the soft like era. Said. The soft era.
In this era, yeah.
I just think
a
like
lot of people weren't
just,
able to cope
just,
with that.
We just like, a lot of stuff, I think, like just creating problems. Like, it's easier than it ever was back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
It's just the freest life.
Yeah.
And then we come up with all this social justice bullshit.
Yeah.
And all that. Why are you creating problems?
Because like, that's what humans do.
Exactly.
We don't have anything else better to do with our lives.
Yes.
That's
what I'm
saying.
It's
a sense
so
of
easy.
Purpose.
We need
once
a
you create a
preach it.
And once you create a problem, you create a solution to that problem. That is your purpose. And once you find your purpose, then you feel so great about yourself. You feel entitled to like your happiness, et cetera, et cetera. Like that. That's people, why we live.
People don't have enough solution-based conversations either.
Because they don't want
everybody
it.
Talking about the that. Problem. They y'all keep talking that. About the problem. Well, is yeah, and people are like this. And shut up. Do you have a do you have an answer?
I think it has to do with this era that we're in. That everybody wants to be a victim.
Victim.
It's
the victim villain era.
Yeah, and like
the VV.
Victim man. Amen. Victims.
I feel
villain.
Like certain people is I can't remember the quote, but it's like. When shit is going good in your life,
yeah,
you kind of look around like, this is kind of suspicious.
Yeah.
Let me find something that's wrong.
Yeah. Self-sabotage. Yeah, buddy.
Yeah, so I think, too, but you're kind of being popular online because it's like, oh, I'll go viral. Some people feel like they can go viral by creating a problem.
Being a victim.
Some people feel like they'll get sympathy or they'll get some love. That's some kind of type of love that they'll get, some kind of attention. By creating a problem. So I think just with this victim mindset is what's driving that to negativity all the time, that energy.
It's the truth. I agree.
What you said is people don't want to hear the truth. I keep thinking a song. I actually wrote a song that drove me to wrote that song. I'm not the one.
Yeah, it's my jam.
It's just like, man, I'm cool. So like, don't bring me your bullshit. Mm-hmm. Don't bring me your drama. Mm-hmm. I'm not fucking with it. So it's just like I'm not the one. So like,
so that shirt would have been a good shirt for you.
Exactly. Yeah. That shirt would have been fire.
Big fact. Shout out to Ashley. Ashley says yes, especially when you're a first responder.
Ooh.
Sheesh. It's got to be rough.
Yeah.
It's got to be rough. What y'all want to do with the conversation? Y'all want to talk about Diddy?
Let's talk about the diddler.
The diddler!
Let's talk about Diddy.
Bring me up. I want y'all to see something real quick, man. So we talked about Diddy on this show a couple months ago. I don't know if y'all remember that. We were talking about Cassie. Remember that? I want y'all to hear this.
Takedown of P. Diddy and his three right-hand men. Okay? Three.
This was
his
4 months
ago. His mouth is being sewn ago. Up. So when I see his face, the image I get is the mouth is being sewn up. So he is going to be unable to speak for some reason. I can't talk. I cannot speak for myself anymore. It's because of his mentors. And they don't want it coming out over here, even though some of them are outing themselves. These are old guys connected to old time, old style Motown. He's being shut up from outing them or from speaking about them for some reason. So there's a hierarchy going on here and there's a total takedown of him. He is being sacrificed. So he may think he gets away with stuff. He may think it's cool he does what he does. But now he's the sacrificial lamb. And I do mean that. There's something that comes up with him in March, speaking of the lamb, during the Easter time frame, March, April, right in that time frame. That's why I said lamb. There's something else that's going to come up with him. We are not done. There are younger musicians that are going to come out against him and talk about what he did. The bodies that are buried, okay? So the bodies that are buried, they're going to talk about it. Talk about it. There are men in other countries who are going to speak about it. There is political connections to him.
All right.
That's big.
Yeah, so, that's huge.
To keep in perspective... That was a psychic talking about Diddy 4 months ago.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's crazy.
Yeah, that's wild, bro.
I hate the word psychic, but
What do you call it? Medium? What do you want to call it? That is a
spiritual.
A spiritual guide or something?
Like a guide.
A guide,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, like
what's
a guide.
What's psychic? Psychic, like is that derogatory?
No, it's
I didn't
just
even say derogatory.
So,
it gives you too much power.
It's just so cliche. Like,
okay.
Like psychics. You see that when you go down beaches. Like, you see, like, psychic this, psychic that, psychic this.
Yeah.
So it's played out.
I get it. So, yeah. What should I call this lady?
She's almost like a freaking insider. I don't even know what she is. She's an alien.
She probably an insider.
She probably got some visions of
some
something.
Pale,
you know what I mean?
You mean but, this pale lady gonna sit back and just Diddy?
Listen.
Why you ain't tell us about? No, man, we're getting to that.
You should have told us about the Nickelodeon.
Why you tell us about him?
But I'm going to tell you the truth. Some of this shit been in plain sight for a very long time.
This black man that popped up in your goddamn head.
A lot of stuff has been in plain sight for a long time. So I'm not, I don't want to get on Diddy for too long because it's been dragged through the mud at this point.
Yeah.
But he does spark a conversation that I want to get to tonight. We're going to talk about how it feels like a lot of powerful men are just falling.
Black men.
Not even just the black ones either. Some of these niggas is falling. Have y'all read the deposition? Have y'all seen any of the?
I think I did a little research.
So many names, bro.
But also did some other research.
Okay, talk.
So the thing about the Diddy thing is, I think they got us. Like they know how to get black people going.
Yeah, 100%.
I don't like that shit. So save for the research, right? Mm-hmm. You had Bernie Madoff, and you look at Bernie Madoff and David Letterman.
Okay.
David Letterman had his little essay case or whatever and stuff like that. All that shit came out. That year came out. That was 2009.
Yeah.
We was about to go in on them, right?
Mm-hmm.
Guess what happened that year in 2009?
What happened?
Michael Jackson died mysteriously. Let's take the attention off of that.
Yeah.
Let's put it on Mike. What else happened? When the Epstein stuff came out.
Epstein stuff came out.
We was about to get into it on that shit. What'd they do?
Yeah.
R. Kelly. Let me go get R. Kelly and go get what he on. Now you got this new Nickelodeon shit just came out.
Yeah.
About this dude. Now, in order to make a movie, you have to have all the facts. They did a Bob Marley movie. They talked to his family.
Yeah.
They had all his evidence and tapes and stuff like that saying, oh, let's make this movie.
Mm-hmm.
You had all the evidence and stuff like that to make this Nickelodeon movie.
Yeah.
But instead of going after him, he chilling. Now to keep us from talking about that shit, now you got Diddy.
Now, they made the movie.
It's too coincidental,
So this is what I want to ask you, because I know you in the conspiracy theories. Let me ask you this question. If any of that stuff would have came out and it was very clear that it came out, what was you going to do?
Oh, I can do nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing. Not a thing.
So my question to you is this. Why are they working so hard to lie to motherfuckers who can't do nothing? That's just my question to you. Yeah. I'm just playing devil's advocate on this. People are always talking about, oh, they distracting us from something. If they wasn't distracting you, what the fuck was you going to do? You can't stop nothing. You
can't stop nothing.
So what are they distracting you for? That's my question tonight.
They would just drop a bomb.
Why are they distracting you from something? If the Earth was flat, for example, you got flat earthers that are real flat earthers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They'll fight you tooth and nail.
Mm-hmm.
Why lie about it? What the fuck you gonna do if the Earth flat? You still gotta go to work tomorrow, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
You still gotta feed your kids, don't you?
It's just the fact that the world is so pressured off of public opinion.
What are you going to do?
It's about public opinion.
But
because of the fact that we talk about the Epstein and the R. Kelly thing.
Yeah, let's talk about it.
With public opinion, you take away the public opinion for us to keep pushing and pushing and pushing for this Epstein stuff.
Yeah.
So you throw us a bone and you give us R. Kelly.
But Epstein ended up in jail and hung himself. Hung himself, right?
But once again, they got tapes and videos of what was going on that island.
Yes.
They got the manifest of all the people that came.
100%.
Ain't nobody got indicted, nothing like that. But the thing about it is, all this stuff, even with what you guys, they talked about, they were able to acquire a warrant with hearsay
Diddy. Agreed.
They was able to acquire a warrant with hearsay. Everybody jumping online saying, oh, he did that, you know, he did this or whatever. Mm-hmm. And you was able to, Homeland Security?
Yeah.
You was able to get that high to be able to raid his shit. But you just made a movie for the Nickelodeon dude, and he's still at the crib.
Hey, shout out to T.Y. T.Y. said there's power in numbers. I guess that was to answer my question.
You take the numbers away.
But what I'm saying is this, too. With the Quiet on the Set thing, do you know Quiet on the Set was just on TNT the other day? I had no fucking idea. Not only are they taking this shit to the streaming services, Quiet on the Set was on TNT, live on TV the other day. Yeah. It shocked me, because again, if they trying to distract us, why you keep giving it to us for free? They giving us everything when it comes to that Dan Snyder shit.
So you said earlier that distraction, why would they try to distract?
Yeah.
Why does any shepherd try to distract their sheep? Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
If you can get a whole bunch of sheep to flock in a certain direction, I can murk more sheep doing that than running around trying to gather one sheep at a time.
Okay.
You have another civil war.
Mm.
Yeah.
That movie come out this year, too. And that shit looks scary.
Because
it looked real as hell.
Watch it.
Just like that Leave the World Behind movie. That shit looked too realistic for me, Jack. I promise you that. So I like what you said. I understand the dynamic y'all putting it in right now with the distraction. Because that's my real question.
Yeah.
What's the point of it?
That is the point.
What's the point of it, dog?
The point is to distract you from what's really going on in the world. The point is to distract you and keep you in a fight or flight senses all the time. So you will not be prone to when real shit is coming over. You'll be so desensitized by it that when real shit actually hits like a bomb, you're still stuck.
On Diddy?
No, on fight and flight. Like whatever else they're gonna send your way.
Right.
Whatever distraction.
Don't look up, right?
Whatever distraction they're gonna send your way.
Right. I get that. I be looking at shit like I said, my whole conversation go back to like what you gonna do about it.
Yeah, it's not you.
You know what I'm saying? So like
you don't be a sheep.
With extraterrestrials, right? You know I love me some extraterrestrial conversations, and I can go deep, but I ain't going to do that. But I'm just going to say 1959, the motherfucking landed here named Valiant Thor. You can look this up, and he worked for the president for 3 years. It's a true story.
Yeah.
But I'm just telling y'all that because what was said while he was here was that they were going to start things like Star Trek, Star Wars. They started all those shows and movies right around that time to desensitize humans so that when aliens actually came, we wouldn't be shocked.
Yeah.
We wouldn't turn on religion. We wouldn't stop buying things. Like, we wouldn't go crazy and start going hysterical. So now when I'm watching TV, all I see is aliens in commercials, aliens in movie shows, aliens in TVs, even the Avengers, even Marvel.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing but some aliens, my nigga. You know what I'm saying?
Reptilian.
And it's so normal that now if an alien landed on this bitch, I'd be like, oh, what's happening? Yeah. At this point, you know what I'm saying?
You might be.
So
we still ain't got no answer for that Miami shit.
We ain't gonna get none. You know what I'm saying? But my whole question to y'all is, like I said, I don't think everything is smokescreen. Sometimes shit be what the fuck it is.
Oh yeah, sometimes it is what it is.
You know
but it's the fact that now we don't, there's no public pressure to pursue the Nickelodeon shit.
You don't think so?
There's no public pressure for that. Cause as black, we only did anything. Now, we think it's funny, we still got memes out. What was the meme? If he did do all this horrible stuff, whether he did, if he did it, why you got funny memes about it? But where the funny memes at for the Nickelodeon dude?
You're right. But I think that's because it's our community as well. So I think a lot of times,
that's why I said they got us.
The black community, we share memes and videos within ourselves. You know what I'm saying? We got black Twitter. So yeah, we own Diddy has. You know what I'm saying? We don't know Dan Snyder like that.
They got us. True. That's what I'm saying.
That's why we're not talking about Dan Snyder like that.
I just don't think that we care to know.
We don't care.
We don't care to know.
You know what I'm saying?
But that's the thing about it is,
you are comparing Dan Snyder to Diddy. Come on.
You see what I'm saying, though?
Diddy is world renowned.
To us, for sure.
Not just to us.
But you get what I'm saying?
He's
even without us.
Renowned.
No, but to us.
Everybody knows who Diddy is.
You know what I mean? Right.
No, everybody knows who Diddy is, but the thing about it, and like, he's not on the same level as Diddy, but the fact remains, Diddy shit is hearsay.
Yeah.
His shit is proven.
Facts.
That's the problem I got.
And I agree with that, too.
His shit is proven.
I agree with that,
you got
yeah.
tapes, videos, all this stuff that you was putting in this goddamn movie. And you didn't get a warrant to do none of his shit.
So
nothing.
You in this industry, my boy.
That's the problem I got.
You in this industry, my boy. Diddy coming to you and say, my man, I can get you a multi-million dollar deal. I love that song that you got. I love the album that just dropped. Why don't you come to one of my parties, my nigga? I need you to pull up. You know what I'm saying? We talk some business. You ain't going to Diddy house?
Let me get them cheeks, my nigga. That's literally what he's going to say. He's going
to
say,
are you going to Diddy house?
Let me get them
what you
cheeks.
Said,
I'm saying that. I ain't saying the cheeks.
Said,
that's Rachel over there trying to offer,
that's
offer some.
What you
she
said.
Offering,
I am not
she offering
shit.
Imaginary
no,
wing.
What I'm you saying, said. Because they got Meeks moaning on Twitter.
I seen that earlier.
Yo, that was wild.
Send that to me. Send that to me. Send that to me. Send that to me. We going to play that.
I just want to hear what you got to say.
Rachel, send that to me. Send that to me. I'm going to play that.
All right. I got you.
All right, what you said, right?
Yeah,
the first initial.
The business part of it, yeah.
The business invitation,
yeah.
Right? I would go.
You would go to the house, okay.
However, once I see what I know I'm going to see, and then the offer is, what she said,
right.
Let me get them cheeks.
Right. Name.
First of all, we
absolutely
my
not.
First
just a sample.
Gonna be, we going to fight.
But, just a sample, yeah. That's
but,
what I be saying.
Yeah,
you tell me nobody swung on this nigga?
Yeah, yeah.
No.
But, it's like, nigga, ain't nothing on this planet worth me
that.
Compromising my body for fucking what?
Yo, manhood.
For fucking what?
Exactly. Fuck
it's
that.
Just like, nigga, this music shit ain't worth it. And it ain't no guarantee.
Mm-hmm.
How many niggas, rappers, actors, whatever the fuck it is, took that deal,
yeah,
gave up the cheeks, and they got shelved.
Mm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Nothing happened. Or maybe they gave you a little taste of something.
Dylon.
Yeah. They gave you a taste of success, and then they ripped it from your ass.
Mm. Give you a sample.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I look like a, I look at Orlando Brown.
Brown. Yeah, man.
And, you know, we've been laughing at this nigga for years.
Vertiner.
But a lot of the shit he been saying.
Nas come to the light.
True, yeah. So it's like, look at his career.
I agree.
He did all that shit. He been telling the truth about these niggas.
And he's actually a talented nigga.
Yeah.
But what happened to his career?
Crazy.
Done.
He known for being a psycho.
Yeah.
That's what didn't make you seem crazy.
What made him a psycho, though?
Crazy work. Amanda Bynes.
Seeing that.
Britney Spears. Yeah. Britney Spears. Exactly. Amanda Bynes.
I'm going to tell you some shit.
Michael Jackson. You should go ahead.
When I was living in L.A., I went to a school called Musicians Institute.
Okay.
And it's on Hollywood and Highland. And, you know, me and my partners that I met out there, shout out to Mel.
Mm-hmm.
We went to a couple of parties and stuff like that. And there was this party in this, it's not a hotel, it's a super expensive ass high-rise unit.
Okay.
And we would see celebrities every now and then, you know, walking across that area.
Mm-hmm.
But in there, they was throwing up a lingerie party. And we got to see a little bit of shit that was going on in there. There was some music people in there, a lot of rock, people who did rock music too.
Mm-hmm.
And the shit I saw,
telling you,
in that little time,
we saw a lot of females go in. Then there was a lot of dudes, but it wasn't a lot of dudes doing some shit with the females. And I was like,
"What are you saying to me right now?"
So basically, the females went in.
Yeah.
Then there's dudes going in. We thinking, "Oh shit, it's about to be an orgy or some shit."
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
We got to see, but there was no females. The females that went in there, we didn't see them. We just saw a whole bunch of dudes.
So it's wing on wing.
Yeah. So then I'm talking to one of the dudes there, and he's not part of that. He was like, "Oh yeah, this shit happens all the time." He's like, "Y'all know niggas do music?" I was like, "Yeah." He was like, "Oh, if y'all want to make it." I was like, "Yeah, fuck this." Yeah.
No.
Nah.
Dead ass?
Like, fuck this. But
video was sent.
But I was 20.
Video was had.
Yeah, I'm 22 at the time, so I'm like, "Oh, no, I can."
That's crazy. Avenues.
But the shit that I saw, I was like, "Yeah, if this is what it's gonna take, fuck
I'm
that.
Cool on that."
Yeah,
real shit. I'm gonna tell you something. I don't think that. Like I said, I'm so surprised that more motherfuckers ain't swung off. When I be thinking of a man, like, okay, so like Columbus Short came out, I think recently, and said he was sexually assaulted and everything like that. I think when men speak about sexual assault, you should take them seriously.
Mm-hmm.
I agree with that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because a lot of them are put in a position where they don't want to lose their finances because they got a family to feed, so they don't want to tell on a nigga, this and that and the third. I'm speaking for myself and a whole bunch of niggas that's listening. You try to touch me inappropriately, my partner, somebody going to jail. Yeah. You feel me? Like, it ain't going to be no 5-6 years later you found out what happened. Y'all going to be like, "Why the fuck did Ball snap on cuz and choke him out like Spreewell?" Like, I'm dead fucking serious. Like, I'm trying to kill you, my nigga. Don't play with me. You feel me? Yeah. Like, that's one thing we not finna do.
Remember
you
Terry
ever been
Cruz?
To jail? I've been to jail. You can't play with shit like that. Because you let a nigga take an inch, he'll take a mile. He'll take some inches in your ass, motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Let a nigga, you don't take favors in jail. You don't even take a favor.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So for a nigga to give you an opportunity and to say, "For you to do this, you have to do this." Yeah. Again, we go back to selling your soul. What is selling your soul?
I'm saying there's a long list of guys. There's a long list of people that told Diddy no. You talk about 50, Fab, Jadakiss. Like, it's a list of people that said no.
I'm cool
the
on
niggas
that.
That's complaining are the ones that said yes.
And then they didn't get what they thought they was going to get.
That's the niggas that's complaining.
Let's talk about it.
That's the problem.
Let's talk about
the
it.
The niggas that said yes.
Let's do it.
He didn't show up on the end of the deal.
You know, they
got the rough side of that.
But even with the rough side, was it Ice Cube? Was Ice Cube this song?
No Vaseline.
There we go. Here we go. So by saying that, I'm asking y'all this though. I think that somebody with the business mind of Diddy, or Tyler Perry, or whoever else, if all you know is rumors and hearsay, you still got to take the meeting. If somebody offer you a business meeting and you do music or you do modeling or anything like that,
you still want to take the meeting.
You got to take the meeting, man.
Yeah.
If you don't, in my mind, you didn't let everybody get to you.
But you don't have to sign the contract.
You ain't got to sign nothing. You ain't got to do nothing you don't want to do.
Yep.
But you need to use your logic and see, get out your emotions. Yep. And you need to take that meeting. You feel me? If somebody was like, oh, you took a meeting with Diddy. Like right now, anybody who ever had anything to do with Diddy, now all of a sudden they gay. Or they fruity. Or they did some funny shit. Or they did some weird shit. Like even Bootsy. Remember Bootsy said something in his song?
He said that.
What'd he say? I just left the city, just had a meeting with Pete Diddy.
Yeah.
In one of his songs, And people like, oh, Boosie. This is Boosie now.
Nah.
Yeah. Don't play with Boosie like that.
Meeks was worse.
Nah, Meeks shit was way worse.
What'd he say? I hope niggas forgive me for what I did with Diddy.
Forgive me what I did with Diddy. What? Wait a minute. That's I hope niggas forgive me for what I did with Diddy.
Wow.
I'm like.
Explain yourself.
Yeah.
Explain yourself.
We heard it. We definitely heard
it. Speaking of that, I'm going to play this video. You sent me this video. Can I get one?
It's very vulgar.
You heard it? Listen, so this is live reaction because I have not heard this. We on?
So ever since the news,
what the fuck was that?
About allegations between a sexual relationship.
Who is this weird nigga?
With Puff Sean Combs and Meek Mills. I don't know Meek Mills' real name, but if this is to be true, man, it sound like this nigga.
Okay. What did we just listen to?
I hope that was some AI bullshit, because that was disgusting.
Could have been AI. Do you think it was AI?
Hell no.
Who recorded the cheese?
That's beyond me.
But if you think about it, to be unbiased, we just heard the nigga that said yes.
That's what we was listening to?
Yeah.
It wanted a nigga that said no. It was a nigga that said yes.
I used to pray for times like this.
This, to rhyme like this. Oh.
I'm sorry.
That shit don't rhyme with nothing.
Too soon.
Don't rhyme with nothing.
Oh, man. Niggas ain't gonna never sing that shit.
Can I say something, though? That was traumatizing.
My heart still beating.
That's why I think it's kind of quiet in here, because
hurt my feelings.
I was hurt.
I'm gonna be honest with you. I don't think I ever heard two dudes doing it.
I thought Meeks was a real ass. I never heard no shit like that before.
The rah, rah, rah.
Now I know why Nicki Minaj left.
Like Nicki left? You think Nicki knew?
Found out.
I think Nicki knows everything.
Where the bodies are buried. We talked about it. Where the bodies are buried. Jesus Christ, that's terrible. That didn't even sound like... Listen, man. Hold on.
Ooh, that was worse than the turtles.
I'd rather see the turtles doing their thing, be honest with you. Hey, they pulled me up real quick. Hey, let me tell you something, though. What we did get out of this... Rap metaphors and riddle out the smoke. Say Meek Mills jumping over Diddy's back gate. Raid the spot. Let me tell you something. Somehow we gotta get the memes that have come from this shit.
Hilarious.
What I say earlier, we good all year. We don't need another situation. We can just go off Diddy memes for the rest of the year, bro. That's you seen the one with his son? Like skip, 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 skip. When you trying to distract the fan. Nigga, I lost it, bro. They had Lil Sean Combs dancing the shit with the sound with the skit, skit, skit.
Nah.
My God. Okay, so like, I can't even think right now.
I'm still.
Are you okay? Are you gonna make it through this session?
Ooh, I need to take a breather.
A little breather.
You mentioned it was
rough.
The deposition, the documents.
Yes.
They were saying that some of the names were redacted, but they were saying it was Usher.
Usher.
And then Meek Mill.
Meek Mill.
And then they kept going back to that song, I Need a Girl, Part One.
But okay.
He was like, he was more than my girl. We was like brothers all night. We would play fight undercover.
Yeah.
And they was like, yeah, this nigga been suspect. Telling who us was, for a while. That's Diddy.
That was his verse?
Yeah.
That wasn't Loon?
Nah, that was Diddy's verse.
That was Diddy?
Yeah.
Okay, because me and my brother don't play on the covers.
That's what I was crazy. Like, I was like, when?
Not ever. You see that 6'5 niggas walked out of here? Yeah. That's my real brother right there. About, that, like, he never cuddled.
Damn, that shit was disturbing, bro.
What did you say, Book?
I'm just saying, like, even with all that shit we just heard and all that shit we hearing, it's nothing illegal.
Which part?
The booty stuff. If you look freaky, having with dudes and have any little freaky parts, yeah. That's
so
not illegal.
So wait, so you for it?
No, I'm not for it. All like, I'm saying is, like, it's not illegal. That is not
he hasn't broken the law.
He has not broken a law.
Cracking man buns is not illegal.
That's not illegal.
In some states.
Like I said, we just called it a freak back
with
in the day.
The promise to give them something in return. And
I don't think that's illegal either.
What do y'all think about what's her name? Young Miami?
Oh, Carisha.
Carisha, right?
Yeah. Oh, 250?
Yeah. You seen this?
Okay, hold on.
Let's talk about it. You know what I'm talking about right now.
So, here's Shay, right? Okay, let's talk. I was like, man, people just saying that shit.
Yeah.
And then she, I don't know if it was today or yesterday, she got online because some fan said something and she was like, y'all just run with everything. Like, talking about I make 200, he paid me $250,000 a month to not only do drugs, but also she a sex worker.
She's one of his sex workers. Yes.
She was like, ain't nobody saying that shit. But then they pulled up one of her old tweets or something she said online. Mm-hmm. And then some shit she said, she was like, yeah, I get over 200,000 allowance from this nigga every month. Mm. She said that.
So she admitted it.
She said that shit, but it was like on some bragging shit. Like,
take that. Shout out to Young B. Yep.
So I'm like, damn.
She told on herself. Yeah. Now, what's crazy is she ain't the only one. Now, when we was talking about Cassie a few months back, and I told y'all, Cassie got that check in 24 hours.
Yeah.
Because Cassie knew where the bodies was buried.
But she also, her husband was also going through a legal battle.
Exactly. But who's to say Cassie wasn't a sex worker? Because in her.
I think she said something about
she that. She said it. She said that he used to force me to do things, right?
Well, he drugged her and then made her.
And me and made her do stuff.
That's illegal, Sean.
And listen, but you can't. This the thing that you can't fight in court, though. If somebody drugging you and making you fuck niggas, and you stay with them for 11 years, it's gonna be really hard to fight that in court. I'm just telling. I'm not speaking from an emotional place. I'm speaking from a factual place.
Yeah,
if you go to court,
like,
you got to take all the emotion and it's all about logic. Yeah.
So, do you think Beyonce is gonna have to do the same thing with Jay-Z?
If the Jay-Z shit come out,
yeah,
not necessarily, no. Because at this point,
have to say what?
Anything that Jay-Z gets caught up on, she knew what was happening.
But she can't say nothing.
She can't fight that.
She
can't
testify against her husband.
Yeah, you can't testify against your husband in court anyway. Yeah. It's illegal. I only think yeah, you can't do that.
Yeah, that's illegal.
Yeah, you can't do that. But I understand what you were saying at first. Like, as far as like the women that's being caught up, it's me. Somebody say it's me and you. Yeah, that's that Cassie. Man, let's play some Cassie in this bitch. Shout out to Cassie. Get that $30 million real quick. But I feel like at some point you have to take some responsibility for something. Diddy didn't force them to do all that shit.
Exactly.
I just don't believe that. I ain't no Diddy. I ain't no fan of him. I ain't taking up for this nigga. I'm just saying at some point as an adult, man or woman, you could have said no. What Cat Williams say? Diddy will invite you to his house, and you got to say no.
You got to say no.
Because you do. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's okay. Yeah. That's okay.
My thing about it is, like, if he did all the stuff, lock his ass the fuck up. I don't believe in none of that shit. They say he did. Lock his ass up.
If you got something,
but my thing about it
something.
Is, take the money off the fucking table. Mm. That's the problem I got.
Okay, talk about it.
My thing about if he was really as bad as Cassie said he was, why the fuck would you take $30 million and leave that nigga on the street?
To do it to somebody else.
To do it to somebody else. Because
you really don't give a fuck.
So all these people that's going at him, keep the fucking money off the table.
Let's talk about
it. Put him in jail.
All the people
you don't get a payday.
If you trying to go at somebody for a civil suit, okay?
Yep.
Let's be honest. You really don't give a fuck about what they did.
Exactly.
You give a fuck about what you can get from what they did.
Exactly.
You give a fuck about what you can get from what they did.
I think she knew what was going to happen.
Why did she stop it?
I think that she knew what was going to happen, and that's why she sued him the way that she sued him right now.
Without all the guys.
Right. Mm. I think that she knew.
She got in and got her.
Yeah,
she
was like, get out the way because these motherfuckers ain't going to get nothing.
Yeah, real shit.
Yeah.
So what you think gonna happen to somebody like Clarisha?
But why we wait to the last minute?
Is it illegal?
I don't think they're gonna go after her.
No, it's not illegal.
Prostitution is illegal.
In what state? In this state, for sure.
Yeah, but not Nevada.
Not Nevada. Maybe she did all her transactions in Nevada.
I doubt that shit.
Give a little coochie up and fly.
Isn't she in Miami?
You can't do it in Miami. Because Florida don't play like that. You can shoot somebody in the face, but you can't sell no coochie. Yeah. Florida, a weird place.
Florida. No, I just got back from Florida.
You can sell it. You just can't buy it.
You can't buy it.
Because they'll lock the man up for buying it, but they won't lock the woman up for selling it.
In Florida?
Fuck no.
Look, in Florida, you can... Don't ask me how I know how.
Okay, because we going to ask questions.
In Florida...
You can sell a little coochie.
Up to $75 worth. Escort service... What am I saying?
Escort service?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Escort service.
Don't act like you don't know how to see
it. You can Google that. And on Miami Beach, it's a whole bunch.
Just outside? Yeah.
Just outside. But no, you can just Google it and just find it and find the place.
Something about buying coochie don't feel safe. I don't know what it is. Maybe I'm just
ignorant.
That's
the safest way to go, I would say.
To buy the coochie?
Because you're going to a professional.
Okay.
Professional.
Uh-huh. She has to keep quiet.
Okay.
Discretion.
She got condoms, okay.
And it don't come back to home.
You know what I mean?
Are you trying to talk me into getting some hoes?
Just saying.
Because you're selling it. Let's talk about it, baby. Who going to Tijuana with me, baby? No, I'm just playing.
I'm just playing.
No, not TJ, huh? Okay. All right. They like, you're going too far. Them bitches, they burn through the condom, nigga. Like,
if you don't pay them what they want, like, your head is... Gone.
Off the table?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm cool on that. I ain't trying to get my head cut off by not paying on some coochie. How you gonna explain that at my funeral, man? What happened to cuz, man? He was cool as hell. Yeah. Got some coochie. Didn't pay
not
on
the
it.
Crickets.
Got the cricket. Yep. Cuz, that's how they gonna be at the funeral. Dead ass.
My thing, like I said, just take the money off the table, man.
I agree with you on that.
I don't like that shit, man. Like, put him up under the fucking jail if he really doing all that shit.
If I'm one of the fathers from the R. Kelly case, for example, and you say, we're not going to give Kelly no jail time, but we're going to reimburse y'all for y'all troubles.
Fuck
that money.
Fuck you.
Exactly.
Put that monster away so he don't touch nobody else's fucking daughter.
Yeah,
but people don't think like
people
that.
Don't want
but
that.
Don't do the R. Kelly scenario because... Those parents put their kids out
there. They kind of knew. But that was the point I was making, though.
Kind of knew. They knew.
Allegedly.
I mean, they knew.
What they from the interviews, they said, it's R. Kelly. What would you do at that time? And
not sell my baby.
Right.
You know your daughter ain't got no talent.
You know your daughter ain't got no talent.
You know your daughter can't dance, sing, none of that shit. And she on tour with all
she can't draw.
You can't do nothing. You know your daughter ain't got no talent.
And you getting this monthly check. And you getting this monthly check.
And you getting a monthly check for your daughter ain't got no talent. What you think
she
doing?
And she gone. And then she come back at 21 all used up.
Come on, man.
All used
up. Looking like a boy.
Looking like a man.
All that shit, man.
That was really sad. That was sad.
But they released him back on the streets like you're saying because... Back when he got caught up with that peeing shit.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just let that motherfucker go back to do it to more.
Yeah, but if that was a little white girl had peed on, he'd have been under the bus. And the fact that they overlook black girls getting fucked up is a shame.
Yeah.
And it's just like they look over it.
Wasn't that on Boondocks? Wasn't that an episode on Boondocks?
Twas.
Where's Boondocks now? Yeah. I say somebody says like, where's Boondocks?
Boondocks was
like,
too real for TV.
I tell you that Boondocks got so much material with this Diddy shit.
Yes, sir. They would have
killed
it.
That's a whole nother season, bro.
Boondocks would have killed it with a Diddy thing. Listen, we good all year on the Diddy shit. Man. We got a lot of material. Speaking of, no Diddy. real quick. Bring me up real quick. I want to say, y'all, we talking about Lil' Brown. Let's talk about it.
Who sold their souls to Diddy? And then they're mad now because the hazing process was a little bit rougher than they thought. You can't be a king. Why do you think I love Diddy so much? You're not gonna dethrone this man because he know how to get you there. By way of hazing you, I call it haze.
Hazing.
And we're gonna still do this. We're gonna still do this. It's not gonna stop. Take that.
It's still gonna happen.
The got 3 million, and we're still waking up in the morning drinking cognac, screaming, bad boy.
So you're telling the truth, bro. They're trying to make that man
but
be
he
crazy.
Sound crazy.
And it won't stop.
That's why
it can't stop.
I'm take him serious.
And it's not gonna stop. You thought just because you got 3 million, you changed me?
That shit made
take care of what you need to take care of. You glad that you got away with 3 million? Mm. Be happy. No, don't you stop me. Be happy you got away with $3 million. I don't give a what you told the cameras. You wanted to be Illuminati.
Diddy wants to party, but you gotta tell him no.
Oh, yeah, well, you do gotta tell him no. You gotta tell him no. You gotta tell him no. You gotta tell Diddy no. Everybody knows you gotta tell him no, because if you don't tell him no, he's gonna put you in a situation where you gonna have to say yes or no again. So just say no. Just say no.
No, Diddy.
Just say no. Because you know the consequences. That's what I'm saying. She said yes. That's what I mean. Mm. She knew the consequences. She said yes. You got to be careful what you sell your soul for, bro, or what you think you're selling your soul for. You know what I mean? Like, you wanted to get ahead. Ain't nobody, don't nobody want you to get ahead. You know what I mean? We're going to make it hard for you. You know what I'm saying? Like, they made it hard for me in my hazing ways. I'm not complaining and saying people did this and did that. They did it. But do I really want to see them in jail? No, I was being hazed. I'm being hazed. I'm still alive. I'm still here. I'm all right. Playing games with my family. It is what it is. If it was a big deal, they would have did the case, the whole trial. Like, OJ, you got Dirty Money. You got Faith Evans, Biggie Smalls. You got so much stuff coming from that umbrella, man.
So a lot of people love to call Orlando Brown crazy because the way he talks doesn't make a lot of sense. But you really have to pay attention to what he's saying. I think he sounds crazy on purpose with some of the things he says, but he gives you facts throughout it. And everything that he says about Diddy makes a lot of sense.
That's actually very
He talks about how just because Cassie's $3 million lawsuit, Diddy won't be stopped. And it's basically because he's so powerful and all the people that still support his brands no matter what happens. Now, there has been speculations for a while because Orlando Brown's last interview that something had happened between him and Diddy. But did y'all catch it? He Orlando it. Brown literally admitted
he
it
did.
This time.
Mm-hmm. I never seen this interview.
You guys think of Orlando Brown and everything that he's saying about Diddy in the comments.
So, funny that that funny looking white girl said that, because I really, really agree with her. Mm-hmm. He admitted it. If you was listening close enough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When he was talking about.
Then he went like
what'd
this.
What'd he say? What'd he call it?
Hazing.
Hazing.
Hazing. Then he shook with it, too.
You know what I'm saying? You remember the freshmen in school when they came in college and you had to throw them in a locker and haze them and all that? They just think that's hazing. Yeah. That's same. Hazing at the highest level.
But he also kept saying that, just tell them no. So it was like, it was like he was asking for consent.
Yeah.
Diddy was asking for consent.
Yeah.
You tell him yes or you tell him no.
But if you want to be in this fraternity, you got
to
take these licks, nigga. Yep. You feel me?
And they wanted
you
to
be in this fraternity, don't you? You know what come with it.
And they
got to take these licks. Yep. And they did it. And he did it. He said he did
it. Say he did it.
So if you ain't going to listen to a nigga that did it, who you going to listen to?
Exactly. Mm.
So I never be like, oh, this shit is fake. Yeah. This is a ghost. This is a, what they call it? This is a witch hunt.
Yeah.
Ain't no motherfucking witch hunt.
You did it. It's just him being freaky.
He a freaky nigga.
He a freaky dude.
But I do agree with him. Like you said earlier, if it was illegal, he would have been in jail.
Yeah.
At this point.
All it just shows is that he had sex with multiple
guys.
Multiple guys.
Or rappers.
Women,
or
now, let me tell you what's funny about
that,
though.
Shows.
Do you know that the narrative is that he don't actually be having sex with motherfuckers? He likes to watch. Even with Cassie and all the mother, like he watch them. He watch these motherfuckers do stuff. Like he's the orchestrator. And I've heard the same thing about when R. Kelly was on his shit, that he was an orchestrator. He was like the director of everything that was going on, which all of a sudden to me just all seems so creepy. It's so creepy to talk about this, to be honest
weird,
with you,
man.
Because we talking about like the fall of powerful men. What is going on in the state of powerful men falling just like left and right, man? And it ain't always sex. And sometimes it's like with Michael Jordan, it was gambling. You know what I'm saying? With Michael,
they tried.
With Michael Jackson, it was sexual stuff. You know what I'm saying?
And when did that sexual stuff come up?
When did it come up?
Yeah, when was that?
Michael Jackson was being
like
accused.
Early 90s, right?
Early.
Early 90s, right?
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah.
You know what came out during that time?
What's that?
So I guess I saved that one.
Mm-hmm.
Bill Clinton and Monica Lewinsky thing. Yep.
So that was, they pinned it on Michael.
So it was like, oh, hey, look at Mike now.
Yeah.
Don't worry about Bill. Let's worry about Mike.
Now, the thing about Michael Jackson is, I think that he was the most victimized of all the big scrutinization people because nothing was proven ever.
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 But people kept getting money.
And even now, those kids came out later in life and was like, yeah, they told me to say that.
Yeah.
Who the fuck? Yeah. Nobody put that interview up? Orlando had, oh, Lord Jesus.
Wow.
That's real. Hilarious. That's, yeah.
It was a little D, too.
It's a little D?
It was a little D.
That's what you heard.
That's what I seen.
You seen it? You seen the Diddy Wee Wee? You seen the Diddy Wee Wee?
No.
Oh, okay. The little D. Oh, he had the D on his necklace. Oh, okay. That's, hey, listen, that's a little telling.
Hey, after you said that, no Diddy.
No Diddy right there. No Diddy. I ain't never had no D on my necklace. Never, no not Diddy. Ever. Even if my name started with a D, it wouldn't be a D on my necklace. Say Orlando Brown was strategic as hell. Hey, I was thinking about that when the nerdy white girl said this shit. She said that, what if he says things like he's crazy?
In that tone
on purpose.
In that tone.
Yeah.
That would be absolutely genius in my opinion.
But that's what I was saying. When someone has a smile on their face and they look happy and they're talking about a really traumatic time, like that Kat? Makes somebody look crazy. Yeah. And it's part and it's part of the show. Mm. It's somebody that smart is that crazy smart, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
To know when to cut it on and know when to cut it off.
Yeah. What did he say? He said, Diddy got some good pussy.
He said it.
Oh, yeah. He did say that.
He did say that.
Yeah. Bussy or whatever he said.
So Diddy doing the bending?
I did not hear that.
I heard that.
No, it was a different.
That was a different interview.
It was a different interview.
God,
this was like when Orlando was like.
He said Bow Wow did too.
Oh, yeah.
That's wild as hell.
You know,
but the rumors about Bow Wow being like that was back when he was younger, too.
Yeah, now, the Bow Wow shit, I ain't gonna never not believe that. I'm keeping it being. Jokes be truth, but in a nice way. Big facts.
Mm-hmm. What'd you say, Steve? I think it's important how she did point out like how he's saying it like he's crazy to get the attention. Because I was watching this, y'all know Charleston White.
Yes.
And there was this, he was talking and he was like, the reason why I talk like this, Nick, is because if I speak the way I actually normally speak, which, you know, he sounds intelligent. He was like, y'all niggas wouldn't pay attention to the fucking thing
I agree with
said.
Him. Yep. Yeah.
He's like, so I speak like this on purpose to grab y'all attention so y'all can hear what the fuck I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, you wouldn't pay attention to it at all.
I agree with
but that.
But that
man is a op.
No. I ain't talking about what he's. I'm not saying
even what he's saying. Like you have to think about it.
The point. Yeah.
He talked. He even said in that same interview. He said, "I used to be talking to congressmen. I used to talk to all these elected officials and stuff like that. I was in suits. I was I had to dress like this and talk like this so just so y'all can hear me."
I feel like Charleston White is a caricature.
And he knows, and he admitted to being a caricature.
Like Kevin Samuels, like Candace Owens. I think they shock jocks. They say shit because they smart enough to understand this is what these motherfuckers are going
to do. That's what they need to hear. Yep.
That's what real entertainers do.
Howard Cosell? What's his name? What's the white boy name?
Dude. Deal No Deal.
Nah, not that motherfucker. The radio dude had Robin, the black girl as his radio. Howard Stern,
yeah.
Just say crazy shit. Because he knew.
Catch your attention.
Whether you like it or not, you was going to listen.
What are you going to say next?
What do y'all think about Candace Owens?
I think she's all right.
You fuck with Candace Owens?
I fuck with Candace Owens, man.
Rachel, you shaking your head.
She say something like, yeah, make it be, everything that somebody says, you're not going to always agree with everything they
agree.
Say.
Agree, yeah.
But she says a lot of intelligent stuff. Mm-hmm. And it's stuff that's thought-provoking.
I think that, Rachel, what was you finna say? You shook your head.
Nothing.
You don't want to speak on Candace Owens?
What does your parents say? Uh-huh. If you don't have nothing nice to say, don't say it.
Just shake your head.
This is one of those.
Well, I'm going to say something. I don't like her. And I ain't saying she ain't intelligent. I ain't saying she ain't right. You can be right and motherfuckers not like you.
Yep.
You see what I'm saying?
Exactly.
If you're an asshole, you're an asshole, whether you're a woman or a man.
Yeah.
To me, she's an asshole. I ain't saying she don't be speaking some real shit.
Yeah.
You can say some real shit, but it's how you say it, like with Kevin Samuels. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? He was saying some real shit, but your delivery is everything sometimes.
Everything.
Yeah. Don't talk to me crazy.
She doesn't like the black community at all.
I don't think so.
At all.
And then you married to a white man.
You.
In that case, what black man you know would be, if Dr. Umar was married to a white woman and he said all the shit that he say, would you take him seriously? I'm being honest. And yeah. I'm all about interracial relationships. Right. I think whatever you do, you do. You right. love who you love, right? But if you always talking about black people and always talking about how we can do this and do that, but you married to a white person.
See, the thing, but she also supported Trump heavy.
Loved him.
No, she supported Trump so heavy.
She gonna do it again.
And was like, for black people, like, it was enough for me.
She says we're stupid.
It's a whole YouTube reel or short just on black women that support Trump. Have y'all seen that?
Yes, I have. And did you see that black woman who tried to join a chat room and they kicked her the fuck out?
Yep.
A black woman, Trump supporter, very intelligent woman, big time. She was up there in the ranks. She joined one of them Trump chat rooms, and that man said, and I quote, "We don't really need support from people like you." They kicked her the fuck out the chat room.
Yeah, which is funny because he's not getting elected without us anyway. So.
But my point is, all them people that are talking that Trump shit, they don't want you on their team, bro. Go to a Trump rally and try to hug some of them white people and see how they embrace you. See how it work out for you.
White supremacy at its finest.
You got to understand it's more than politics when it comes to that motherfucker. It's the climate of the country. And that's what I be saying when it comes to that Trump shit. But I ain't against him or for him. I'm just saying what I see.
Well, they said they had more for him this go around.
Hell yeah.
Because of the situation that he faced. You know,
he
about
gonna
to go
win.
To jail. So
he going to win.
Well, he went in the last
Look at
spot.
Me. He gonna fucking win. And when he get in there, watch this. Clip this part. When he get in there, watch this.
Yeah.
That's all I'm gonna say. That movie that's coming out this year, that motherfucker's a documentary, nigga. That Civil War movie that's coming out, it's not fake.
I think the Civil
War. Y'all gonna wake up. I spent 12 years in the military. I watched this shit happen in front of my eyes. Why should I tell you? Somebody said it's the shoes. It's the Trump shoes.
You got your gas mask ready.
Did you see what he did, though?
Which
do you,
part?
Do you know what they're talking about? Like,
which
the
part?
Shoes? Mm-hmm. So, Trump.
Oh, made, yeah. That
yeah.
ghetto shit. Go ahead.
Yeah, Trump made some shoes.
Oh, yeah, I did
and
see that
said
shit.
That
he got a Bible.
Yeah.
I can't speak on that. All I could do is just speak about the shoes, because that was just wild to me.
Mm.
This
you got
man
money,
made
do what
some
you
shoes
do.
And uh-huh. said that. This is what America looks like. This is for Americans, insinuating that black people was gonna buy these shoes. And because the black community was gonna buy these shoes, that he was gonna win the election because they bought the shoes.
You know them shoes sold out, don't you?
Yeah, what's
wrong
with that?
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
How many people you know with them shoes?
None.
Not damn nobody.
None.
No. Not a soul.
None.
No.
Because we don't live in rural America. We don't live in the fucking outskirts where all the dummies live. Sorry, I apologize. But ain't no universities in them fucking towns.
Oh, yeah.
When you see the voting, when you see all the red is and shit,
there
ain't no
that.
Schools where that red is. Ain't no universities. Ain't no education. Ain't no motherfucking nothing.
You can't get mad at people that are voting for Trump right now.
I
look,
can't.
Look at what we got as options.
Can we get a new Nick in here? Like anybody else, no Joe, no Trump. Is there anybody else? I was a Bernie dude, be honest
Me
with y'all,
too.
Back in the day.
Me too.
Because when they would speak, if you got ears, if you got a mind, and you heard Bernie Sanders talk, you was like, oh shit, this motherfucker know what he's talking about. You know what I'm saying? But
man, put me on. I got you.
He never got. He said,
I run for
on. You go.
I go.
What you got for
put the boogie in there?
What you got for us?
Put
man?
The boogie in there. Cause
give me two policies. What you got? Which is two things you are gonna change right away?
Oh, no,
President
Bush. I ain't even gave him a thought.
He didn't either. When
kinda,
Trump got in there.
I just kind of do it off the top of my head. Just off the top of my head.
Man, when Trump got in there, he walked up to the podium. He was like, he was waving like, damn, nigga, I won this motherfucker.
Yeah.
He's like, shit, let's start signing shit. Remember the first day he was just signing off on shit.
Yeah. All my shit gonna be sports. Trump won. He speak his mind. You got it, bro.
Yeah,
I'm saying by presidential. Yeah. You know, I would say by presidential. the NBA All-Star game. Will be competitive.
There you go.
You
gonna change the answer.
And Jordan
you
is
gonna
the
change
GOAT.
The All-Star game.
Jordan the
That's first my presidential first, policy. We changed an all-star game.
But in 2024, you would probably be the most presidential nigga in the room. Because you say shit like, yeah, you bust 60 nuts in the bitch. And you know what I'm saying? You say things like bust 60 nuts in the bitch.
60, why not?
Yes, and people sir. Be like, what the fuck?
Let it ride.
So you've been married for quite a while.
Right.
I want to talk about marriage, man.
Absolutely.
I want to talk about marriage, man. I'm getting old. And I'm starting to think about it more and more.
Yeah, man.
My twin sister getting married tomorrow. Shout out to Rachel. I love you, baby. I love you so much.
It's not me, Rachel. Guys. It's not me.
Not that Rachel. My twin sister Rachel getting married tomorrow. Throwing that out there. But it made me start thinking. How is married life, man? How do you think life would have been for you if you didn't get married?
Probably the amount of kids and diseases I would acquire would be through the goddamn roof. You know, God put a woman in my life.
Herpes siphy God for me.
God put a great woman in my life for a reason.
Okay.
So, and if y'all don't know, this is my wife.
My boo. This is my boo.
That's my baby right there.
Yeah.
So now y'all know. Y'all done met my baby, man. Y'all done met my baby, man. My wife of 19 years going on 20, man.
I love to see
4 kids. But yeah, definitely. I would say we talk all the time, and it's like I think we kind of saved each other.
I love that.
Yeah,
I think we kind of saved each other, man.
I'd have been a whole hoe.
That's how you feel.
A whole hoe.
What I'm hearing, pop locking on the handstand.
All my single friends, they should not take my advice.
They call you pop locking still.
And that's
on gang. That's what the young people say on the gang.
That's beautiful.
That's deep.
That's the truth, man.
19 years, man.
Yeah.
How y'all feeling?
Feel good, man.
You look young.
Yeah, man, we're looking forward to the next 20, man.
Y'all look good.
I just watched a couple that was 100 and 103 celebrate their 82nd year anniversary.
That's crazy.
We got the 82 years, man.
82 years?
Yeah, I look forward to that. So then when I was talking to him the other day about that, he was just like, I'm trying to make it to 80.
Well, I'm just trying to make it to 80.
I don't know.
To 80 years old.
Trying to get me to 100?
And I was like, that's deep. Like, damn. Hell yeah.
82 years of marriage?
Hell yeah.
I know what your fart smell like. Like, baby, that's you? You know what I'm saying? I know all
of it.
I know everything about you in 82 years. That's crazy work, y'all.
She said the biggest thing that she would say for married couples to do is to have a communication.
Yeah, talk it out.
Talk it out.
Talk shit out.
Like, sit down and just really talk shit out. Mm-hmm. And don't be just one-sided when you talk shit out, because I had that experience to me not too long ago where I felt like, not with you, babe.
We talking.
With a good friend.
Okay.
Where I felt like the message that you were trying to portray was just one-sided, one-noted.
Okay.
And when I tried to give my input, it seemed as if I was being defensive. But it wasn't. It was just me talking it out.
Understanding.
And understanding. So that's something that we hold true to, is that we communicate and it's not one-sided. Like I don't go in with my mind made up on how the conversation is going to go.
Mm-hmm.
I go in open and hoping for a relief from the conversation.
Damn. Okay. Damn.
That's big, man.
You're teaching me a lot. I learned a lot from him, but having you here is a big deal. I've been dealing with this nigga for 3 years, and the things he says sometimes, we wonder what kind of woman deals with it, right?
Yeah.
And now we're seeing it, and now that I'm listening to you talk, like I said, I've known you forever now, and just knowing your mindset and y'all mindset together brings a nigga hope. So thank you guys so much.
She used to me, man. Everybody kind of, you know, y'all know I'm going to talk the shit.
Yeah.
Like they told the big mama being 37.
Yeah, big talk.
Popping her shit in the club, you know. Oh, yeah. But I'm going to say what I say. And
mean what
she
you mean.
She's so used to it. And she know my opinion on stuff. I know her opinion on different stuff. Mm-hmm. And like, and if I'm capping, she already know.
Y'all see this on the screen? Who paying 400? Hey, put that back up.
Man, why
who
not,
paying 400 for the cop or drops? Y'all copping it or dropping it?
Drop
if it want that T on the side, I got to holler.
They got Trump in the drop.
If it didn't look like Tommy Hilfiger and Trump made a baby, and
they do look like some Tommy Hilfiger shoes. I never thought about it.
Yeah, you know what I mean. If you take, I was like, take the T off, cuz. I said, yo, bro, take the T off.
Hey, no. Tyrone's like, I'm putting the T on there for Tyrone.
Yeah, no. You know, see?
I got them Tyrones on. No. I don't know. I can't jam. Can I say something
but look
about...
At, look at the Trump. Look at the Jumpman.
The logo?
The Jordan logo.
The Trump man. Hey, you done came to high school with some of them on, we done tore your ass up. You hear me?
Depending on what high school you went to.
Roosevelt High School, St. Louis, Missouri. You walk in the lunchroom with them on, your ass might as well turn around. Okay. Baby.
So, because if you was in Richmond, Virginia, you went to Henrico.
Yeah.
Yeah, you getting your ass toe up.
No, you probably wouldn't get your ass toe up, babe.
I don't know.
The certain part of people would cheer you on and march.
Oh,
right,
yeah, it is a Virginia. Yeah.
It's Virginia. Come
in
on.
In St. Louis, you'd have walked in the lunchroom with them on. You'd have had to cross paths what we call the zoning table. I don't know if y'all know what the word zoning mean, but in St. Louis, zoning is like roasting. We had a zoning table where it was all the class clowns in one place. Them niggas would have looked at you and be like,
Come on, get some.
Come on over here. Nah, let's see him. Oh, yeah, that's what I thought they was. And them niggas would have took turns on your ass.
Yeah.
Flaming you until you went home early that day.
But then you had to come back with more ammo tomorrow.
Yeah, you got to write jokes. You got to write jokes in St. Louis. Them niggas do not play games.
They call it shaming now.
It's shaming.
We're so soft.
It's bullying.
It's called bullying and shaming now.
But hazing is going around, apparently.
I don't the new hazing. That's Diddy shit. I don't think we doing no more. I ain't hazing no more. I don't know how to use that word no more.
No Diddy.
The diddler. No Diddy. That shit funny as hell to me.
So the diddler. Steven, let's talk to you, baby. The diddler. Rachel with the diddler.
That's just funny.
So that's
nasty
word.
I don't come up with this.
I don't know why the diddler sounds like you cannot let that nigga watch your kids. You cannot let Uncle Diddler. Not the diddler. Yes. Man. Don't let the diddler watch them. Y'all get diddler away from them kids.
Yes, sir.
Get y'all uncle away from them babies.
What happened to you, baby? It was the diddler.
The diddler.
It was the diddler.
I don't care what a nigga named Diddler did, he did that shit. If they said he did it, he did it. Steven, you've been married how long?
10 years.
10 years. Yes. Congratulations, my boy. Damn. Let me ask you the same question. What do you think your life would have been like without marriage? You'd have ended up like me. out here wandering in the world of clouds and shit, nigga.
I don't know, bro. I for sure would have been a hoe of some sorts. Okay. I'm pretty sure I would have gave that shit up a little earlier.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because the whole life gets old.
Because at my core, real shit, I'm a lover boy.
Okay. Romantic ass nigga.
Even though I know she watching.
Niggas will tease you for that. Get your little I love bitches ass. Yeah.
Nah, but that's always been my problem, right? That's been my problem, though, mm-hmm. because growing up, I had my two cousins, shout out to Danny and Stuart.
Okay.
Them some hoe ass niggas.
Okay.
And
he gave love first.
That's what family do, baby.
They some hoe ass niggas. Okay. So growing up, you know, they was like, you know how it is. Like, hey, little nigga, you gotta get you some pussy, you know what I mean?
All the time.
But it's like every female that I came across, it was like, instead of just running through them, I caught feelings. It was just like I cared, you know
you
what I'm saying? Like
I would
listen. I wouldn't go that far, but I would like. But I cared, you know what I'm saying? Like while my homeboys just like fucking sticking the movie,
kissing.
You know what I'm saying? Hell no. But it was just like you know what I'm saying?
You
like
supposed
I
would to care.
Cover,
you
weren't supposed to cover.
Yeah.
You
so you know like you hit, yeah. You dip. Me. Not me. I hit, I stay.
You cuddle.
Yeah, and I'm like, first of all, I never understood the concept. Especially you got some good ass box.
Yeah.
I'm not about to hit one time and be like, all right, dude.
I'm good.
What are we doing, man?
I'm coming back.
That's
like,
a bad
can I have
investment.
Some more of this? You know what
Please,
I'm saying?
Please, sir.
Yeah, that's me.
Can I have some more stuff?
So I would have been a hoe, you know what I'm saying? To a certain degree. Like, mm-hmm. and some then I probably would have failed for somebody.
Yeah.
But
shout out to Jackie.
I'm glad I did get married. You know what I'm saying? Because she helped me. She complimented me.
Understood.
I saved her as well.
Mm-hmm.
It gotta be like
yeah.
It gotta be like that. Man.
Yeah, and then I'm happy too because a dream of mine. You know, I grew up with both of my parents.
Oh shit, yeah. I think
they
that
still,
makes
they
the
still
difference,
together.
Man.
Yeah, they still together. So I growing swear, up, dude. Seeing that, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, man, I gotta have this for myself. So it was like, I don't want to be, and I was big on like not being statistics.
Yeah.
The cliche with black men, like mm-hmm. you know, we got multiple baby mamas. So I was like, fuck mm-hmm. that. I'm not
gonna be me.
I don't want no baby mama. Period.
I like that.
She gonna be my wife. So. That was a big thing for me, and I ended up getting that with her. And then another thing is just like, first of all, this marriage shit is hard.
Yeah.
Hard as a motherfucker.
Damn, you gonna say yeah in front of her like that?
It can't be.
No, it's hard. It's hard.
I'm listening because you know I'm like, shit, I've been preaching this for a minute.
Okay, so listen. Listen, for a single guy like myself, a lot of married niggas have run me off from getting married. But more than that, a lot of married...
They were unhappy.
But a lot of married women have run me off from getting married.
They were unhappy.
Because I fucked married women not knowing they was married. Because
they were unhappy.
You get what I'm saying, though?
Yes.
And that's scary. Because if you fuck a woman on a Wednesday and then Friday, she's taking pictures and posting pictures with her husband and kids, you'd be like, damn! You a cold piece of work, baby! I don't want to be the nigga. I'd rather be me than him. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. I would rather be me on this side getting played with than be somebody that you giving your life to. Yeah.
But that's when you go in with somebody that's not equally, what should I say? I always say yoked, but I'm trying to get a word that's...
Can we talk about equally yoked real quick?
Yeah.
Because I don't think people know what that means. Y'all know what the yoked? Anybody know what equally yoked mean from a physical standpoint?
Spiritual standpoint.
Now, from a physical standpoint, in the fields, they have something called a yoke. You ever seen like the oxen's like pushing the yoke? That's called a yoke. Mm-hmm. And if one oxen is behind the other, the field don't get plowed. You have to be equally yoked for things to actually work. And that's where the term equally yoked came from.
Nice.
From the from the fields of plow. So
if you don't have that and you go into a relationship with somebody, sure, that could happen. But if you go in with the understanding, look, I'm not playing games. Yeah. You can't be with anybody else and I won't be with anybody else and we are together. Yeah. This is us. If you decide that you want to step away, let me know and let's have a conversation about it. And then you do whatever you find that you need to do.
It's very grown.
But that is a very grown conversation that usually comes in after hurt.
Numbness or hurt?
Hurt.
Okay.
Because.
Something as far as being yoked.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We're not having that conversation after I smash. After I smash, then we can have that conversation. Then we'll see if we're equally yoked.
Man. You think that's... No.
Yeah, we got to have that conversation afterwards. Afterwards, it's like, you know what? I don't think you're really heading in the same direction I'm heading into.
Okay. He can't help himself. Let me tell you why. Let me tell you why.
You got to be yoked, though.
Even with her here, he can't behave.
Let me tell you why he capping right
why
now.
Why am I capping?
Talk.
Because,
let's get it.
He talked to me on the phone.
Yes.
For so long.
Yes.
And we talked about, like, even having children.
Yes.
Okay.
Or what it would look like. What does family look like to you? That was one of the questions that I asked him.
That's a big question. I don't
what
think
does family look like to you?
That's a good question.
We had some really, really deep conversations before he smashed.
Right.
Before he smashed.
Before he smashed.
Okay.
So I knew. Whether he knew it or not, that he was going to be the one.
Okay. That makes sense, though. Because a lot of women say that. You got to hit him here first.
And
go ahead. I'll let you
and he had already had me on the conversation.
So you knew the coup de cat was going.
And I knew, you know,
direction.
The box is good. So okay. I'm like, yeah.
Give him a little sample.
Give him a little sample. Okay. Let him know what he's working with.
I fuck with it.
You know, and then after that, he's been
here I go.
Stuck to me ever since.
Look at Reese.
So let me
Reese like, yeah, bitch, with that.
Let me.
Reese so over there, so rolling her rooting for the
box. So everything she's saying is true.
Yeah.
Everything she's saying is true.
Yeah.
We talked on the phone.
Mm-hmm.
She was not nowhere in proximity to me. In between that, wait, we talked for like 3 weeks?
Yeah.
Was not in close proximity to me.
Okay.
So what happens is, what you do is you talk the shit.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, you feel how you feel, but you can open up a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? But then what happens is, as soon as she got in close proximity,
yeah,
the box was had.
Because she knew.
Because she knew.
I had already made up her mind.
She already made up her mind.
Is that true, right?
She tried to make it seem like I convinced her.
Yeah.
But it was in her mind, too.
I just do that for ego. It's fine.
Yeah.
I fuck with that.
Yeah. I was going to ask Rachel, do y'all women already know you're going to give up the coup de cat? Before you give up the coup de cat? Or is it a circumstantial thing?
Here's the thing. I can't speak for no other woman.
Do you know you're going to give up the coup de cat?
And it depends on the type of man.
Okay. Have you ever been on the phone with a nigga in your mind you said, I'm going to give him some coup de cat?
No.
Okay.
No. I already knew what he looked like.
Right. Yeah, right.
I already knew what he looked like. No. We talked in high school. Yeah. No. Like, I already knew what he was about.
I can. So for me, like, we can have a conversation over the phone, but I need to see you in person. I need to know the kind of man that you are in person. Mm. And usually, like, I usually go to like a bar or like somewhere. Damn, this shit broke. Whatever, that's ghetto.
We lie. Go ahead.
I like to see the type of man that he is. Like,
face to face.
Yeah, like, is he looking at other women when we're together? Like, is he trying to talk to my friends if we're together?
That's
like,
deep.
You know,
that must have happened.
Like, stop it.
Yo, when you be saying shit, it be sounding super specific.
No, because
specific.
It has. Okay. It has. Yeah. Various different types of situations.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I feel like you could just tell, you know.
You know.
Yeah.
Yo, when you be talking, I swear to God, you be like, and then sometimes guys come over at 3:30, 2 p.m. and then be like trying to ask you questions about how you was, and I'd be like, this shit really fucking happened. Mm-hmm. Every time you talk, I'd be
like,
damn.
It's only experience.
She only talks about her own personal experience.
That's all you can.
And that's
about.
All you can.
Yeah, that's very true, very true. So with that being said, I want to ask the married people in the room, what would you give advice to somebody like me and Rachel, right? I'm not married.
Well.
Do you want to be
context,
married?
Context.
Okay.
I'm divorced.
Okay.
Happily divorced. But me and my partner were together for 7 years. We have one son together. And honestly, we have a better relationship now than we did in our marriage.
And that
took time. And that took communication. That took, like, a lot, you know. Because if I was to tell you guys, like, my story, like.
We'd be here for a while.
Yeah. A minute.
But
trauma.
I'm asking this though. When it comes to longevity, 10 years, 19 years, when y'all 20 next year?
This year.
Yeah.
November.
17.
What we doing?
I remember it.
What we doing though? What we doing though?
Oh, you remember that anniversary? Now,
I want to be a part. I want to be a part of this. Because Dub is crazy. 20 years is in 2024? 20 years is crazy work.
Yeah.
It's a lot going on this year.
Shout out to y'all. So I'm asking 10 and 20 right here. What is the key to longevity? Because I'm just trying to keep somebody for 3 months at this point. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, they just find better. Like, you got to think about the options. Remember I said something not too long ago? I said, when does never settling turn into never satisfied?
Right.
And that's what I'm experiencing. Yeah. It's like women will be like, okay, he's good enough, but I can do better.
Placeholder.
He's a placeholder. And I'm the placeholder nigga. You know what I'm saying? And I just found it.
I really like that you said they go out and find better.
That's but in their mind. See what I'm saying?
Okay.
But you was talking about before, the illusion of options.
The illusion of options.
The illusion of options. Because there's so many niggas in your inbox.
There's
niggas
and
with
stuff,
money
yeah.
and there's niggas with six packs and tattoos that is gonna take you on trips.
Them
niggas don't give a fuck about
them
you.
That's not better.
You see what I'm saying? No, but they don't know that's not better. You get my point?
Yeah.
They think that they're gonna get what I give them in that nigga. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So they go explore that. But you can't come back, baby. You see what I'm saying? Yeah.
So,
but they call that dating. Oh, that's okay for a woman today. I agree. But you can't come back. You can't come in and out, baby. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that's why I fall. That's why I fall short. And that's why I can't sit down nowhere. Because motherfuckers always see me like, oh, he's good enough. But let me keep going and see if I can find something better.
See.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay. I have, my issue is my trauma. I am tired of dating men that are not going anywhere. They're not trying to do anything.
Mm-hmm.
I want more. And I feel like me being single right now is that. It is my freedom. It's, again, situations.
Yeah.
I've dated around and I'm just like, I don't want any of this. I don't want the nonsense. I don't want the jealousy.
Yeah.
I don't want any of that. And at a point, like, I find satisfaction with healing myself. And once, like, I know if I fully once I fully heal myself and work on my inner child and all that other stuff, like, I know that that person will be there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think that for some people, like,
It's a timing thing. I do agree with
you know?
That, too. But y'all found the right timing. How did you fucking do it? Nigga, you said 10 years. How old are you now?
35.
So you was 20. Five when y'all, right?
Yeah.
What made you do it?
Well,
Well, we high school sweethearts, first of all.
That's a big deal.
Of course, you know, off and on shit here and there. Mm-hmm. I think for me, just kind of being so young, again, it goes back, a lot of it has to do with how I grew up.
Yeah.
Seeing that shit. So it's like, all right, number one thing was, is she a family person? How does she treat her family? Yeah. How is she? What is her goals and ambitions in life? Not that she needs to be. I'm not one of them niggas. What do you bring to the table? Type shit like that. It was just like, how are you as a person?
Yeah.
How do you compliment me? You know, because I want a challenge. Like, if I'm ever fucking up, which we all gonna fuck up, and I know I'm gonna fuck up, are you gonna hold me accountable? Are you gonna be like, are you gonna motivate me? Like, hey, babe, like, you got this. Are you gonna get back on your feet? Do this. Mm-hmm. This. You know, when shit hit the fan, how are you gonna help me get back to me? To where, like, when I'm in a dark place, you gonna be my person to bring me out of it, right? So it's like she was that person, and then
it's a big deal.
You know, being so young, it was just like, you know, I dated, we both broke up and stuff like that, and it was just like me seeing the options I had. It was just like, man, no disrespect, but the females at the time, it was like all y'all care about is clubbing. You have nothing for me except I'm a fuck. And to me, that doesn't do anything for me past a nut. Like, what they call it, post-nut clarity.
Yeah.
It's just like, that's all I can get from this person. And that's okay. If that's what type of time you on, that's not what I'm on. It was just like, I have no interest in just fucking somebody long-term. And like, this dating shit, like, that just wasn't for me. So it's like, with her, she brings out more, if that makes sense. And then two, the big thing is that my family rock with her, because my mama didn't like nobody, but she rocked with her, and it was just like my sister rocked with her. That was a big thing, because
that was huge for me too.
Yeah, they two important people in my life, so I was like, okay, y'all fuck with her, I'll fuck with her, so you know, maybe this thing will be pretty good, and vice versa, like her family fuck with me because she half Mexican, half black. So it's like, A big thing too was, besides my personality and my character, it was just like, I knew Spanish. I grew up around Hispanic people, so that side of her family really rocked with me as well.
Oh, that was real.
Yeah,
good.
So that's just like how we was just like, fuck it, let's do it. I was against it, to be honest, because I was so young. I'm like, man, 24. We actually got married at 24. Anyways, you know, it was just like, you know, I didn't want to do it because we were so young, and I was just like, you know, what if X, Y, and Z happen? But it's like, we don't know the future, and X, Y, and Z gonna happen anyways in our lives, with or without each other.
Long as we're together.
Like, yeah, so it's like, might as well just do it. And it's 10 years. So my advice to y'all, if you want to get married, I say keep that as your focal point. You're gonna find your person. It's like my dad used to say, I mean, there's 8 billion people on this planet.
Facts.
The odds is in your favor to find somebody. Somebody.
Good somebody. And don't always think, like, if you get with somebody, the tragic thing is going to happen. You're going to cause that problem.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You already going in thinking it's going to have problems. Like, not to say that it's not, but when you go in like that, you already, like, conjuring up some of that already. So just go in it very open, I would say, you know, as a relationship advice.
Mm-hmm.
Be your true self. Don't put on, you know, the dating face.
The dating face.
You know what I'm saying? Be your true self. Be your open and honest self. And the right person will be able to reciprocate and respect that.
Okay.
And be able to show you their love for you.
I agree. I always say that too, about putting out what you get back. And I'm hoping it works out for me at some point, because I just started talking like this recently.
Yeah.
But I started hearing people talk about how bad the dating pool was. I don't believe that. I don't buy that. I'm not going into that shit. I don't care what people say. You trying to tell me that ain't nobody out here good enough for you?
That's a you problem.
You the only person that's honest. You're the only person that's loyal. You're the only person that brings something to the table. You can't tell me that, man, with a straight face. You know what I'm saying? So when a woman starts talking like, ain't nothing out here, in my mind, I'll be like, you must not be shit, because you attracting not shit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's how I think when I hear people talk like that. Yeah. So don't tell me that it ain't nothing out here, because now I'm looking at you sideways. You see what I'm saying? Because it's women out here right now that's fighting off niggas that are good niggas.
Yeah.
And they fighting them off. And they throwing you the scraps because they have positioned themselves to be so obtainable. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They personable. They nice. They sweet. They pleasant. And this nigga's fighting to get them. And they just scrolling through. They swiping left.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but we can flip that. Mm-hmm. We can flip that on the side of is dudes that's with good girls.
Yeah.
And being DMs and gone and doing all of that.
They need to lead them dudes and come get some of these niggas that's good niggas.
And I get it. But it's almost like in today's society, I see a lot of women raising their boyfriends. I like saying that.
That's crazy word.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And they have boyfriends. So they seem to raise them somehow.
Yeah.
And they like that experience rather than being with a man friend.
It feels empowering to some people.
Yeah.
Some people want to fuck with somebody that's less than them.
That shit don't last. That was gonna be my advice was, first of all, find somebody that is where you are.
Yeah.
In your place in life.
Agreed.
Like, you're thinking about, like, so, you know, being young. Like Steven talking about, like, just being young. Like, y'all was in the same place, so y'all able to build some shit. A lot of people, and then nothing is, you got to be each other's first choice. If she feel like she's selling for you, or you feel like you selling for her, that shit ain't going to fucking work.
No.
Agreed.
You have to actually, like, damn, this is my person.
I think that second choice shit is the most underrated shit.
Which one?
When we talking about second choice.
Second choice.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people ended up with people that wasn't their first choice.
Yeah.
And I don't never want a woman to pick me if I wasn't first.
Yeah.
Ever. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? If you had to go test the waters with that nigga and then come back to me, that's why I said before.
Yeah.
If you got to go do something and you got to come back, just don't come back.
Yeah.
Because then in the back of my mind, I'm always know I was never him.
Yeah.
I was never him. I was just a good enough nigga that at some point you got tired and was like, all right. And I will never love you right.
You ain't gonna never, yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's why I say it's rough, man. It's rough, especially like in the position y'all in, being older or whatever, and trying to get somebody.
I am older, yeah.
Like at least, say for me and Steven, or we put the miles on our white pussy.
I got it.
We put the miles on that motherfucker.
Somebody else is putting the
miles. Somebody else is putting the miles on the shit, on the shit that you end up getting. You feel what I'm saying?
So, yeah, that's crazy work.
It's rough.
That's real.
To think about it like that is wild. Somebody else putting in some work right now on my coochie.
You ain't never spent a block.
Somebody said, "Have I ever spent a block?" I have, but when the block was spent, the respect wasn't the same.
Yeah.
When somebody came back to me, I told her in her face. She said, "You feel different." I said, "Because I am."
Yeah.
At this point, I don't trust you with me. Mm-hmm. I don't feel safe with you, and you know why? Because you change your mind too much. So I'm here, but I'm not all the way here. And she felt it. She wasn't stupid. You know what I'm saying? And that's the truth.
Yeah.
So you can come back, but you're never going to come back the same.
No.
Because yeah. I can't accept you the same.
It's either when you come back better, or you come back for the worse.
But now when you come back, I'm watching you from the side eye, though, because I know you will leave.
Yeah.
A motherfucker who will quit on you once will quit on you again. I promise you that. They going to quit when they get ready. Because right now, you make sense to them today. Tomorrow, they might wake up with a whole different attitude.
So what happens when you're in a committed relationship and this person wakes up with, I want to quit today, or I don't feel like... See, because you said, what's about longevity?
That's what I'm trying to figure out.
This is the key.
Talk to me.
The key is... When that person is ready to quit, you don't put your hands up. You get the digging and you start the working.
You do. When they want to quit. Why would you want to stay with a motherfucker that want to quit?
Because you changed. Something had to change.
For them to want to quit on you?
It had to.
You sure?
Something had to change in the relationship. You just not going to wake up one day and say you're going to quit.
I got to agree with that.
Really?
Yes.
I agree with that.
Who?
So in the retrospect.
Look at his face.
In the retrospect, you know what I'm saying? I'm just saying.
What's up, Marissa?
When somebody says they want to quit when they had an out in a longevity relationship, you supposed to inwardly go on yourself and find what are you doing in the relationship or something like that. And then have that person, when they're ready, to do the same.
When they ready.
When they're ready.
How long do you wait for them to be ready? Because what if this person telling you, you're not doing nothing wrong, babe?
No, that's it's not a person me. Being truthful. It's when you me. Have a person that wakes up yeah. and you, 20 years is a long time.
I agree.
And not every day I wake up and I'm like the most chipper person in the world. I can say that just in, it's you understood. Know.
That's human.
But I never want to quit. That's one thing, because I like a challenge and I always admire our challenge. So you want to find somebody that, first of all, how long had they had a job? Okay. Because when I got with him, he was already on his job for 5-6 years and we were young.
It's consistency.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. He felt like quitting some days.
But he didn't.
But he didn't.
Every time she cooked a meal, I want to go back to work. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, I get it. I understand.
Do you understand where I'm coming from?
I do.
Because someone, as you wake up, and you might want to quit.
Yeah.
But do you got you see that other person working? You now you get it.
Yeah, I get it.
You wake up, you might want to quit, but you see that other person working when they feel like you might want to quit. They bringing flowers. They saying, baby, I love you. They saying they showing themselves a good time. They're doing all that stuff. They're doing the work. And that's what keeps you going. Mm.
You like you inspire each other.
You recharge each other
yeah.
on those days when you feel like you want
to
quit.
To that's me, deep. I think that's the mindset of a married person, and that's why y'all married. You get what I'm saying? Because a lot of motherfuckers don't do that.
That's not true at all.
They will quit on you. And you ain't got to be doing nothing wrong. Ain't nothing got to change. Somebody could be married for 15 years and get out of a 15-year marriage and then date you and you the next nigga.
And something changed.
And something changed yeah. in what they thought changed.
Something.
Because something triggered them. That had nothing to do with you and what you was doing.
Sometimes
what
their
husband used to do.
I beg to differ sometimes. I really,
you fuck with a woman that was married for 15 years?
No, but I'm just saying, like, we mirror each other. Mm. If we're one, then we mirror each other. If I wake up and say I want to quit, then something's changed in him and something's changed in me.
Somebody.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Both. Not somebody.
True, it's both?
It's both. When you're married and you're marrying.
He been consistent the whole time.
Been consistent. That's fine. But something has changed.
I think I do agree. It's not. Cause there's too many variables.
It's a lot of variables.
In the answer to that question, right? So to piggyback off like what you're saying, because somebody cannot be doing anything wrong. Mm. And there are people that will wake up because they have their own motivations. So I hear this a lot, right? So like what you're saying is in a marriage, the way to have it successful, right? They'll say, we need to become one. We need to be on the same accord. You know, we communicate, you do all the good shit. But then there's also this popular saying of, yeah, you know, we're married, but I also am an individual. Mm. I also need to, you know, do shit for me, which is cool. But it may be that, you know, while y'all together, maybe one, you know, y'all was on the same page here, but then this person, as they start aging, maybe in their mind is like, oh, I feel like I'm missing out on something. So I need to go to the club because my friends, maybe you have single friends or your friends is doing something or you're watching a certain group of people doing something and maybe that your married lifestyle is keeping you from doing some shit. So there's going to be some people that wake up and they're like, you know what? I want to be able to do this. Mm. But I can't because, you know, I need to respect what we got going on here. Mm-hmm. But then they feel like they missing out on something, so they will go step out. They will go do some disrespectful ass shit.
So it's FOMO.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I've seen, you know, and I know a lot of married couples, and then some of them are divorced. Some of them are going through a divorce right now. Whereas it's like, one in particular, and I'm not gonna say any names, she out of nowhere, the worst that he does is he comes home after working and he'll go out in the patio just for an hour.
A breather.
At the moment.
Yeah.
He makes sure she good, he makes sure they son is good, and he'll go out there and he not cheating, not texting nobody. He just out there, he sits, makes himself a drink. And he's just sitting there sipping, listening to music or watching a game on his phone.
You need that.
But in her mind, she has one of her homegirls she likes to party. She's single. You know, they have fun together, but she's out there fucking on niggas and doing shit. Just living a single life.
Is so she a whore?
So now what she's doing is she feels it's okay because I'm not cheating on you. So let me go do these things, but not understanding that you keep putting yourself in a certain environment. Eventually, you're going to feel like I need to be a part of this. So then eventually what happened? She started cheating. She started doing drugs and all this other shit. So it's like, it's too much.
So you're thinking it's just the friend's influences or the mindset of the person.
It's what they wanted to do anyway.
Yeah, it's a factor. But at the end of the day, we all adults. Nobody's forcing you to do this shit. Mm-hmm. So it's like, you are the problem. It's not that necessarily that person, your partner's doing something wrong. It's just FOMO. Mm-hmm. I missed out on this. Or your own mind is fucking with you. It's not always that they did something. Because at the end of the day, in a marriage, you should have communication. So if somebody's not doing something,
right?
Or they're doing something that they're no longer doing something that they're supposed to be doing, you should be having that communication. Like, hey, babe, like, you're not doing this. Or, hey, babe, you're doing this. I feel like that's wrong. Like, hey, how can we get to understand? Now, if over time they just don't correct that shit, they don't give a fuck, then I understand you waking up like, okay, I'm done, I'm leaving. Yeah. That is understandable. But when you just wake up out of nowhere and you just like, you're not doing this, and it's a you
problem. It's coming from somewhere.
It's a you problem, or somebody got in your head, or you just feel there's the illusion of options. And it's not always another person. The options that you have, like, I have time to do this, like,
yeah.
And some people, what they do is, I heard you talking about how, you know, you've been that dude that slept with a married woman.
Yeah, it's terrible.
And the crazy thing about that is, like, why are you still holding on to that motherfucker? Because you want to step out and do this shit, but then in case it don't work out with this dude, I got something to go back to. And that's some selfish shit. That is some selfish ass shit. And I never understood the concept, because I ain't gonna lie to you, that's always been my fear. Not that I'm saying my wife's gonna do it, but I'm just like, damn, at any moment, there's so many things that can happen. I could be that nigga that is like, I'm clueless. And she could be doing some shit. You know what I'm saying? That's been a fear of mine, which is why I didn't want to get married when I was younger. Cause I'm like, man, this shit can happen. But it's like, If I'm always gonna have that fear, I'm never gonna take that leap of faith.
Yeah,
I'm never gonna know. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, but anyways, I do agree with what you're saying to an extent. I agree with what you're saying because there's too many variables.
I agree with what you're saying too.
Yeah,
but I also know that when you're supposed to be together in an equal situation, then it's really two people to blame. Is never just one.
I tell you what, I'm gonna agree with you because you've been married for 20 years, so you got the seniority on this one. I'm just, the only point I was making was sometimes you don't have to change for somebody else to change their mind.
Oh no,
that's all I was saying.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying.
Yeah, I
agree. You can be consistent as shit. You can always be you. But people are in different places in their life at different times. And you might be here. You might be a steady force. And a motherfucker might be living their life like this.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? And today, you know what I'm saying?
Like
you can just be that nigga.
Like we talked about before, it's about communicate so that you can arrive at that line. It's a line you end up getting to between boredom and peacefulness.
Yeah.
You have to communicate so y'all can arrive at that line together.
Yeah.
Because it could be either way. When one person is peaceful, the other one is bored. I want to go do some shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And vice
versa.
You gotta
communicate that.
Communication is that one thing that we don't talk about.
Like, y'all know.
Consistency is boring.
Consistency
is boring.
Consistency is
boring. That's what I was saying, though.
And that's what marriage is going to be. But you got to be able to communicate. Like, if I'm just sitting there, like, same kind of thing. Like, I sit around, I'm in my garage, I'm watching sports, YouTube, whatever the case is.
Mm-hmm.
She ain't got no problem coming in there.
Right.
Hey, I'm bored. I'm ready to go somewhere.
Yeah,
I want to go out to eat.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay. I'm like, you know what? She's like, you've been sitting in this garage for 5 days straight. I was like, you're right. Let's go out.
Let's get out.
Yeah. But everybody's life is so situational. You know what I mean?
Agreed.
I think that it really all comes down to emotional intelligence. I think a lot of people lack emotional intelligence. Mm-hmm. That goes to what you were saying with like the line in between boredom and peacefulness.
Mm-hmm.
Like if you can't see that your wife or your husband is suffering in any type of way, any shape or form, like, and you're not trying to step out and do more and be more,
Facts.
then of course they're going to feel like they're lacking. Of course somebody else is going to feel like the other person is not doing enough or they're not doing enough because they have lost their sense of purpose within the relationship.
Yeah.
So I think that it's really situational. I think that we need to have more emotional intelligence and, like you guys have been saying, just communicate.
More conversations. The communications is a big one.
I wouldn't just say communication because we can communicate about anything.
And not be saying
shit. Know, but if you're not coming to that solution to why you feel the way that you feel, then it's not going to go anywhere.
So have you ever heard like people say like, oh, this person is never satisfied, right? Mm-hmm. Let's just say that I make $100,000 on the nose every year. I don't make no more, no less. When you first met me, $100,000 was a good amount of money. But now 5 years later, you're like, nigga, why you don't make no more? You see what I'm saying? 10 years later, he's like, nigga, you still making $100,000? Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? When you met me, I was a shit, though. Let's say my dick was 8.38 motherfucking inches, right? Mm-hmm. That dick gonna be good at first, and then it's like, okay, I done had the same dick. Now my pussy didn't gravitate to your shit. I need 9. You know what I mean? Let's say that your motherfucking sense of humor was funny. You was funny at first, but you ran out of jokes after 5-10 years. At some point, some nigga gonna be funnier with a bigger dick, with a bigger wallet. And he gonna start looking real tasty to you. I didn't do anything different.
Yeah.
You just got tired of my fucking...
bored.
Basic shit.
It has to be.
But what is basic, though?
Exactly. That's like, what I be saying. You ever hear people say that term now?
There's no such thing as like normal. The bare minimum.
That's what they call it now. You ever hear this? The term bare minimum?
Yeah.
I won't take the bare minimum. That's the bare minimum. What the fuck is the bare minimum? Because your bare minimum might be different from yours and yours and yours.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What's the bare minimum?
I don't think that they're capable of having those types of conversations.
Mm. Again, emotional intelligence.
And I agree with you 100% on emotional intelligence.
Sure. A lot of people can't even handle the truth. So.
And then when you're telling them the truth, they have this big emotional response that is not even warranted for the conversation.
Because they weren't ready.
I was telling a friend the other day, everything that you're saying is correct. How you're emotional, what I wanted to say, how you're being emotional is wrong. Mm. But instead of saying that, I said everything that you're saying is correct. How you're going about it is a little wayward.
Mm.
You know what I mean? And I had to explain it in a very sensitive thing because that person is emotional.
Yeah.
So I have to be able to
articulate
what I'm saying, and you have to like validate other people's opinions too. So everything that you're saying is right, it's just you're not emotionally stable.
Understand
why you're saying it.
Understand that, yeah.
The delivery.
I don't give a fuck about the delivery. Tell me the truth. Tell me the truth. I don't give a fuck how you say it, man. Just tell me how you say it. I'm just saying on a personal thing. Just tell me how you want to say it. That's fine.
If she came home and was like, if it's the truth, it's the truth. I'm not sucking your dick because it smell like peanut butter.
Damn.
Take a bath.
Then I need to go take a fucking bath.
Yeah.
That's the operative word.
I'm like,
just go do it.
Super blunt with him, but in the same token, he's fragile.
In the same token. But because he gets over shit.
No, Oh,
you not? No, I'm gonna keep a grudge.
You are the grudge master. Ooh, I forgot about that.
I'm a hold.
Okay,
so princess.
Yes, sir. You got that
petty
right.
Princess.
You got that right. Petty. Why? Because I give people too much credit.
Okay.
Because somebody would do, and like, we had, you know, it's kind of like the marriage kind of thing. Mm-hmm. Like we had, she had to tell me. Sometimes you are so condescending. Mm-hmm. You can be this way, and
you're
I was
a
like,
dick.
I can't.
And
be.
I love you.
Yeah, and I can be. Yeah. But it's one of the things because I give people benefit of the doubt. She's like, well, I did something to make you mad. Why didn't you tell me?
That's true.
Because I gave you the credit that before you fucking parted your lips and said it to me, that you thought about it. Yeah. That's why. Nope. I'm giving you the benefit of the doubt. She's like, no, I didn't even think of it like that.
Nope.
I didn't even think of it like that.
So, like, you could, like, she's like, and that's how it is. Like, she could say, I could be a little fragile. You know, I'm a Cancer, as they say.
Yeah. Y'all both Cancers?
I'm a Cancer.
No, I'm a Libra.
What does that mean?
I'm balanced.
Okay.
Them scales,
that's what they told you.
That's they said, what they told me.
I said, I'm not sensitive. I'm passionate. That's what I say.
I'm a Gemini, and they tell me.
Oh, you fucked the fuck up.
That's what they tell me all the time. Just like my brother. But in my mind, I'm like, am I though?
Well, I seen you turn it on and turn it off, so I know what you're capable of.
I'm capable of emotions.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's normal. In my opinion.
Okay.
In my mind, I'm like, as a Gemini, you can't get mad. Because people are like, oh, shit, here we go. I'm like, damn, nigga, I can't get mad, girl. Nigga stepped on my shoes, girl. Like, damn, I can't shoot this bitch up.
I don't know.
Gemini men aren't that bad.
What's your sign?
Aquarius.
Y'all be lying? What's the Aquarius? What the Aquarius be doing?
They're dreamers, and they like...
Them niggas be lying.
And they like...
You be lying?
No, that's Pisces.
See what I'm saying? That's what some lying ass nigga would say.
Do you want
me to lie to you?
I feel like I
lying ass nigga.
Okay. For me,
yeah.
Like if I'm communicating, if I'm I'm very emotional. If I'm yelling at you, if I'm expressing myself to you, if I'm like confiding in you, that means that I like you. Okay. And I'm telling you about me. And if you don't give a fuck about me, I'm out. You won't really hear from me. No talk, no text, no nothing. Like,
do you want to be married again?
I would like to.
I talked to you and Melvin about this. Shout out to Melvin. Shout out to Freezy. He's somewhere in this motherfucker.
He stepped out.
Y'all both been married before, and I asked y'all before, do y'all want to get married again?
I feel like it would take a very special person for me to marry. I've been through so much within my marriage that it shaped who I am now. And I feel like who I am now, I actually love and appreciate. And I can't have somebody that is going to tell me that, like, what I feel and how I feel just doesn't matter. You know, just because they can't deal with their own emotion or they don't know how to deal with their shit, you know. I would like to, but...
Don't happen.
I don't think so. I'd rather be the rich auntie.
But like they said, like I said, with that emotional intelligence thing,
yeah,
you got to be prepared to come with it also. Mm-hmm. We seen that shit. You got to be prepared because a dude or any person with emotional intelligence cut your ass off
in a minute.
They like, oh, she don't know how to control her emotions. I'm out. I'm like, no, he petty.
You know what's crazy about that?
I'm emotionally intelligent. I'm not dealing with your shit.
I actually studied this at college, emotional intelligence. And I realized that I had more of it than I thought I had. And that's why I was really single. And it's funny because people with emotional intelligence usually end up being single. And it's fucking sad. And it's only because we understand. Like, things will happen. Things are logically will happen. Logically will happen. You know what I'm saying? You're not the best looking nigga in this bitch. You're not the nigga that's the most attractive to her. You know what I'm saying? You don't speak the best. You don't got the most money. You ain't got the biggest dick. You ain't got the best as a human. You ain't got the best conversation piece. You not the best nigga for her in every aspect. Yeah. You got to know that. And I think emotionally intelligent niggas understand
But that's what the bare minimum shit come in at. You talk about like the bare minimum stuff. It's like.
I only got a couple of those things. Like,
if anything, what is your bare minimum? If you got a bare minimum standard, say if he got to make six figures, he got to do this, do that.
Yeah.
And I've said it before. Stand on business then. Why you fucking a nigga that ain't at your bare minimum?
If it ain't at your bare minimum.
Because you sure is fucking ugly.
Because we already talked about
it. Yeah, you fucking a whole lot of niggas.
If you are 6 feet tall and you make $100,000, if you are the combination of the two things, if you are 6 feet tall and make $100,000.
That's 2%?
You in the 2%.
Yeah.
That's a true story.
That means, but you fucked 10 niggas that was 5'8". Stand on business. If that's your fucking standard, stand on your business.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah.
That's the problem.
But
I saw a statistic that said people who think that way, right?
Yeah.
That there's only the same group of people are fucking the only same. 10% of the same people.
That's a true story.
So when you say shit like, ain't these niggas ain't shit. These bitches ain't shit.
Yes.
Because you fucking the same.
You fucking the same.
You're competing with the same fucking pool.
You're digging in the trash. Again, why I said, when I'm talking to a woman and she say some shit to me like, ain't nobody out here to date. Dating pool full of shit. Ain't nobody out here. In my mind, I'm looking at you.
They're dating the same
and
shit.
And I'm saying to myself, oh, so you like shit.
That's what you dating.
That's why you're getting
shit.
Well, could you say that same thing for
yourself? No, I can't. Because the women I date, usually it don't work out because of situational shit. It ain't because they was trash. I would never say I fuck with a woman for a long period of time.
So he's not saying women trash.
No. I would never say that. It's a lot of good ass women out this motherfucker. Single women.
So you been with a lot of good ass women, you just didn't lock.
Scenario. Cause sometimes when you're 42, about to be 42, I don't want a child that's 5 years old. You see what I'm saying? If your kids is old, then that's cool. You know what I'm saying? I don't want a woman who gonna give me problems. And a lot of times, a lot of women come with problems. Yeah. At 42, I can't do that. At 22, give me all your problems, baby. I'm good. I got the stamina. Yeah. I can chase you. 42, I can't do it, baby. I gotta go sleep.
Well, technically, you should.
See what I'm
saying? You should be with another woman that is raised.
Some rest.
I need a nap.
You should be with another woman that's raised by now.
But you see what I'm saying? That ain't as common as you think it is.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? And then a lot of women that are my age have been divorced at this time.
Mm-hmm.
They ain't trying to get married again.
Understood.
See what I'm saying? They got situations in which what they are, the women my age ain't dealing with nothing. When I say Nathaniel, I mean Nathaniel. You don't text them back fast enough, you gone, nigga.
Yeah.
You don't call them back right away, you gone, nigga. They don't even give it, they don't even give you a chance to know if they like you or not. For real, for real. You cut the fuck off. One mistake, you a bad day away from getting X'd
out. So what would you say to the girl or to the woman that wants to be with you?
Be patient. Be patient and get to know me. Know me, because I can tell you something.
Say it in the camera.
If you know me, you know that I mean
say
well.
Say it in the camera.
You see what I'm saying? That's all I'm saying. You know what I mean? Like, a lot of niggas don't mean well. They really don't give a fuck about you.
Yeah.
They're trying to fuck, and they're trying to get it with you. Like, I don't need to fuck you every night. I don't need nothing from you, first of all. I don't need your money. I don't need your body. Because there's
said,
a lot of bodies
you said
out
that
here.
You want.
I want. That's all yeah. I'm saying. I don't need nobody. I can cook. You ever taste my cooking?
Mm-hmm.
You ever taste my cooking? Anybody taste my cooking?
She had the crack. She had the shrimp this morning.
Oh, you had the leftover?
Yes, it was
how
fire.
You feel? How you feel?
Fire.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
How you going? How I'm a need a woman when I can cook better than a motherfucking woman?
Ooh, that it depends on the woman.
Not better than me because we talked about that.
Talk to me. What you want to do? What you want to do?
You came with that macaroni and cheese.
I messed up one year. I fucked up the mac and cheese because I tried some new shit. And you know we don't try new shit on Thanksgiving. Yeah. Niggas don't play like that. I ain't never lived it down. I bounced back.
Oh yeah, wasn't that my recipe yesterday that you made?
No.
It wasn't?
You had what kind of pasta? You had bow tie pasta?
It doesn't matter the pasta, it's the sauce. It's the sauce.
That's my sauce!
I was tasting the pasta.
You
saying,
took my sauce!
No, you took my sauce!
I've been going sauce crazy for a while now. I'm gonna say you that
so,
right now.
But when you came over and had my crab boil, did you not taste my sauce and say that you was gonna recreate that sauce and do it again? That was my sauce. I tasted it.
Can I be honest?
So you out here stealing recipes?
Can I be honest? First of all, she didn't give me the recipe. Yeah. The fact that I could taste something and get and all the recipe. That's some Dobby Flay shit.
He was
first
in
of
my
all,
refrigerator.
And second of all, you had the reggaetoni shit with the filling and the cheese. What was that shit she had?
I don't know.
What you had?
Was it yolk?
What are you talking about?
It was stuffed something.
He
it
doesn't
was
even
cheese
know.
In it.
Oh, tortellini.
You had tortellinis.
Yeah.
And I was like, damn, the tortellini go crazy. I actually went home and made that like 3 days later, and it was fire.
I know.
Last night, I didn't do that.
So
bow tie
I say
pasta.
To you.
I went bow tie.
It went bow tie.
And I never did bow tie in my life.
You need to find a cook in your life.
First of all.
Somebody's going to give you a challenge.
I'm a cold ass nigga.
Somebody that's gonna beat your ass at it.
But
that'll be dope.
What I tell you earlier, if I had a wife or a woman who was like a healthy person who can help me make meals and healthy meals, oh, I'd be a different nigga.
That's what I'm saying.
Give me some consistency.
You're
know
looking in the wrong thing. You need to go down. Chefs, you need to go down.
Like, you gonna give me a big girl?
Yeah, you're looking in the wrong category.
Give me somebody who's trying to change her life.
Yes.
Not the mid mac and cheese ball.
Listen, first of all, my mac and cheese is not mid.
That's what it is.
Who said that? Put it back up. First of all, return to the Mac.
Yeah. He put Velveeta.
He redeemed himself.
Talk to me real quick.
You
y'all,
was busy.
Let's just keep it a beat.
Every year.
Y'all
you are the mac and cheese guy.
Who do the mac and cheese?
You're the mac and cheese guy.
He does.
Now, I fucked up 1 year, and y'all ain't never let me live it down.
Never. Never.
Not
that's
the
how
mac and
niggas
cheese.
Is, man.
Not the mac and cheese.
Talk to me about that mac and cheese now. It's the first thing gone. Yeah, year. Don't play with me like that. Okay, but my point was this. It's really hard for me to, at this point
to say I need a wife.
Yeah.
Because when I make my mouth to say that, I sound like I'm lying.
Well, because
all my bills are paid. When it comes to sex, my hand is really, really handy.
Right.
And when it comes to sex, you get it when you need it. I can last weeks and weeks and weeks without some sex.
My husband would beg to differ. Like,
well, that's your husband. He says he had in-house coochie for 20 years.
He says that he rather need than want.
Oh yeah, we discussed that.
We talked about that.
And when you say,
I'd rather be wanted than needed.
I understand that, but when you get a chance to be needed,
yeah,
and it feels like you wanted it, maybe something it will change.
I agree with you, and that's what I mean. Maybe one day I'll get to that point.
Yeah.
And that's a deep ass shit that you just said, low key. Like, I think that at one day I feel like I need somebody, that's the motherfucker.
Yeah. When that person walks away and you and instantly can't breathe.
Yeah.
Gina.
Yeah.
That's when I feel like I need you, I can't live without you, I can't function without you, then I'm going to sit back.
Yeah, like we said, when you find what it's like finding the one you want and then realizing that's what I needed.
Damn.
Yeah.
Damn, y'all make my chest hurt.
I cannot relate to none of that shit.
Cause she a player for life.
She a player for life.
Stop it. Stop it.
I don't need no nigga for nothing.
I can't relate to none of that shit.
I don't need a nigga for nothing. Nathaniel.
I agree. It'll come together.
Rachel, you don't want nobody? You don't need nobody? You don't need nothing? Want nothing?
I feel like I can't say that. I can't, as a woman, I can't ever say that. I can't say that.
Oh, it's gonna rain.
Man, and I'm worse than, just wait till you get older, man. That was as, all this stuff gonna fall into place when people turn 55.
I'm getting older now.
I can't almost wait to go to your wedding. Citizens.
Just wait, when you ain't got nobody to change that fucking pamper.
That shit gonna be lit.
When you ain't got nobody to help you to your fucking doctor's visits and shit, like, you find out.
Yeah,
people find out. But you settled in.
I needed
somebody. And then you need somebody. You shitting all over your goddamn self.
Mm-hmm.
Juice running down your leg and shit.
Come on,
anybody,
man.
They don't nobody there to help you.
And give me a break.
That's terrible.
I met an Uber driver that was 60 years old and married a Kenyan 30-year-old woman.
Mm-hmm.
And the funny story is that she's a nurse and that one day she's going to be his nurse. Mm. And he just loves that.
That dynamic.
So he says, that's like, so when they're holding hands or they look awkward together or something, he makes her push him in a wheelchair and do stupid shit in the store.
Yep.
Yeah, it was funny. It was hilarious.
Yep. So, yeah.
Aight. What's going on? I wanted to give a shout out to my sister before I got out of here. Can we pull me up real quick? Ooh, yeah. So this is my sister Rachel right here. This was today. And these little, her brand new nieces, brand new cousins was making her art. And this was us tonight just having a good time. I just wanted to give a shout out to myself before I got out of here,
Rachel.
Man. That's Rachel right there. So, yes, tomorrow she ties the knot.
Congratulations.
That's the family picture, as you can see. TJ over there looking 6'9". Beautiful
blended,
beautiful blended family. You see my daddy with the Cardinal shit on representing St. Louis. You know what I'm saying? Bassem is Middle Eastern. Met his dad today. Amazing family. Amazing family. They were so fun, so welcoming, so open. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So loved it. I loved it, man. So experience. So this is Rachel and her friends just having a good time today. This is my sister's page. If you ain't ever seen my sister before, she dope as that thing. That's her on the right there dancing. She 42. And she's still moving like she 25. You know what I'm saying?
Get it right.
Bang. So shout out to Rachel. Rachel Thomas, man. My twin sister. My ghetto twin. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Really, really proud of her. Been in this thing for a long time. Rachel told me she would never get married. Never get married. And somebody came along and changed her mind, and she felt like she needed them.
I'm looking at Rachel. Get it on this video.
It goes stupid. It goes stupid. She goes stupid. You see that?
Hey.
So that was them. This birthday. Is the new house that they bought together. And you see me clapping. But right here, I thought about something. I was listening to Cardi B when she was talking about like how 50-50 shouldn't be a thing. Like 50-50 shouldn't be a conversation. It should be individually. Mm-hmm. And for Rachel and Bassam, shout out to Bassam, my new brother, man. They did it their way. They put their money in together. Yeah. They did everything together. Mm-hmm. And they built things together. And that's the way they took it. And that's what worked for them.
Because it's not 50-50. It's supposed to be 100.
100, 100. 100. Put it all in, man. If you ain't all in with me, don't bring your ass over here. Just love her so much, man. It's just my sister. I just wanted to show some love to Paige before I got her here today, man. You know what I'm saying? Just letting know how we are, because we jam. Me and Rachel go all the way back like spinal cords and car seats, chief. You know what I'm saying? We go way back, man. So, shout out to my dad.
I saw someone, man.
Yeah, it was my pops, man. No, he tried to hang in there. He couldn't make it tonight.
It was some of those, the Knicks.
Which one?
The Knicks.
The Knicks. Oh, what?
Oh,
we lost to the Spurs today.
Oh yeah,
this is my little brother. He just left here.
You don't want to talk about that.
I'm just trying to change the subject.
We're gonna go back to that. We're gonna go back to that seven. What is he, seven foot yama is what I call him.
Wimbenyana.
Yama.
So if y'all don't know, I'm a Knicks fan, huge Knicks fan. This nigga's a Spurs fan. We played them tonight.
Yama.
We lost in overtime, but we didn't play anybody. You know that, right?
It was a good game.
We benched all the real niggas. But the dude we did play, he scored 60.
Yeah, 47 40? Shots. But he
scored 47 shots, but he scored 60-something. 61 or something like that. Brunson.
Oh, right. Man.
And he 5'10".
It matters. Y'all lost.
We did lose. Anyway, but yeah, I digress. Man. But this is family right here. Just wanted to show y'all that real quick, man. Before we get out of here, Steven! Yeah. What you got coming up? Y'all had a show last night, man. I was pissed. Nobody told me. I was pissed. Yeah, nobody told me. C13, if you're listening, your mama. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we got another one, I think, on the 13th.
What day is it on?
Saturday.
Damn. I hate Saturdays. Be at work.
But I am going to be throwing another event.
Okay.
Like my birthday.
Am I singing at this event?
Yeah, you definitely.
you telling me right now?
Yeah, just let you know. Yeah.
For sure.
It's not because I gotta plan it out.
I get
stuff
it.
Like that. So
we'll talk.
We're gonna do another one. It's gonna be bigger than that.
Okay.
I am gonna be charging at this one though.
Yeah, for sure. It's not
a birthday but yeah, you definitely singing.
Okay.
You're gonna be back to popular demand, baby.
You feel me?
Yeah.
Why I gotta pick the one that he's gonna charge on? God damn.
We got you. Don't worry
my
about it.
My soul just dropped. Like,
y'all good.
No, he had food and everything.
I'm just joking.
Hey, he gonna rub it in talking about he had food and everything.
Yeah.
I was tired.
I footed the bill for that one. So,
we got you this time.
But no. This one's gonna be, it's not gonna be expensive. At all. I got love for the people. I want people there having a good time.
But the album is doing well.
Yeah.
That's
and
dope.
I'm very proud of you.
I saw it come up on my Spotify.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. It was like a new release. You had a new release on Spotify. And I was like, yup,
nigga,
Mike.
I meant to tell you that because, you know, I shuffle songs a lot of times because I DJ here on the radio, Dream Radio, every Friday night, 7 to 9, drink kickback. And I was shuffling songs, and one of your songs popped up on a shuffle.
Yeah.
Literally an Apple Music shuffle. Yeah. And I said, oh shit, this nigga got the algorithm going. You know what I'm saying?
That's love.
I'm proud of you.
Yeah,
dead
appreciate
ass.
It.
I'm dead ass.
Yeah. We gotta get that that collab album going.
We got it.
Yeah, we got it.
Best
that.
Of both worlds.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Oh, speaking of, we might as well tell everybody. Mm-hmm. Not next month.
Okay.
Because I want get a little warmer. We definitely gotta shoot a video.
Shoot a video for which
one? For both.
Oh, stop playing with me.
Yeah, definitely.
Let me get in the gym, get the body right so I can get out there butt nakedness with the all night. Look at Rachel.
No Diddy.
No Diddy with the butt nakedness.
Yeah, nah, none of that.
He said, I'm trying to be.
I ain't trying to be soft bodied in the video either. Right. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Get the tough body going.
He got a freak nigga.
Get your tank on.
Get my tank on.
He talking about for all night.
All night. Yeah, I gotta have. I can't have no shirt on for all night. I like that you know the music. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
No, but I gotta definitely have my sexy on if we gonna do a video.
Same.
So let me know.
Same.
April, shout out to Tori the Body. She got a fitness challenge coming up, 30-day fitness challenge, if y'all want to get in on that.
I need to do that.
I'm getting in on Tori the Body. If you're listening, I'm coming in there, and I'm doing it again, and I'm going to kill it the second time. So I killed it once, and then I gave up and started eating honey buns again. Because honey buns be so good. Food be too flavored. It be too seasoned. Be too good. So I'm back on my shit, though. I'm back now. You know what I'm saying? Yep. But April. Yeah. April, I'm going to get right. When we shooting?
I'm shooting for May.
Do you want to go to Cancun?
For your birthday?
No.
To Puerto Rico.
Do you want to go to Puerto Rico?
Yeah.
Yeah, your birthday, right?
Yeah.
When is it?
Memorial Day weekend.
Jackie, I'm going.
Sorry. Jackie, we going. Memorial Day weekend, because we can shoot it in Puerto Rico.
Oh, that's fire. Yeah, we going.
We'll talk about it.
We going, Jackie.
We'll talk about it. Rachel! Thank you for pulling up, Mommy.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
How you feeling?
Good.
You need a shot?
Absolutely.
I got you.
Yeah.
We're going to get out of here in a minute. So, we talked about marriage tonight. Mm-hmm. We talked about deity tonight. We talked about family tonight. What stood out to you tonight? I think that marriage shit hit you in the head.
That's
you know, everybody keeps asking me, like, Rachel, are you going to have another kid? Yeah. You're getting older. Yeah. You know, I'm just like, all right. I think that Amias should have a sibling, but I'm not trying to offer up my uterus.
Yeah.
And to be honest with you, I really don't want to have a second baby daddy. You know what I mean?
I like, get that for
like
real.
I just don't know how I would feel dealing with the same type of situation.
And you had a husband.
With another nigga. You know what I mean?
I get it. Yeah.
I can't do it.
I get that.
I'd rather adopt a dog.
A dog?
They're harder. I swear. I'm going to kill my dog right about now.
Man, you know? Hey, lay off Cash, man. That's my nigga.
That
man.
Dude's been peeing everywhere. He's going through something.
Yeah, wild seed. We thank you for pulling up tonight in your nice dress. And y'all look coordinated over here on the right side with the black on black on black. You know what I'm saying? I fuck with it. You know, I'm a black. I love black, man. Bro, bro.
What it is,
you
man.
Put up with the collar shirt on today.
Yeah, man. I you know.
Looking,
you
feeling, smelling like a million bucks.
I had to do it, man.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I had to do it. I had to do it for the day.
Is that
what it was?
What, you got the fives on? Yeah. Fours on?
Oh, the fours.
Ooh, fours. Stinking green.
I got some ankle socks on. My ankle's ashy as that thing.
Hey, listen, but listen. But you
married, can't tell it.
But you married.
I guess I'm going to put some lotion on my ankle.
Yeah.
Hey, I had a partner. I swear to God, I had a military partner. Every time he would do something, he would like fart or something. We'd be like, ugh. He'd be like, I'm married. I'm like, definitely excuse me for being gross. You know that, right? He'd be like, nigga, there's somebody musty as fuck in this bitch. He'd be like, it's me. I'm married.
I like, that. Bro,
that don't give you a pass to be gross, that. Nigga. I'm married. I don't care what y'all think about me. My wife love me.
Yep.
Man, appreciate you pulling up, being me in perspective today, man. Y'all giving me some wisdom. I actually learned a lot tonight, believe it or not. Just talking to you married niggas, man. Like, I love it. I love the experience. I love to talk to people who have done things that I haven't done. You know what I'm saying? Been places I've never been. You can never be... You got to be humble enough to accept things. You know what I mean?
Yep.
And tonight, I feel like y'all fed me. Fed me enough to where I can come out of here with a different perspective. And I hope anybody who's listening came out with the same. Step!
What's up?
Thank you for joining us tonight.
Oh, thank you for
What's the page
me.
Again?
It is, it's cooking without the G.
Cooking.
Yeah, cooking because I'm country.
Uh-huh.
Around the world.
Cooking around the world.
Yep, that's where you can
with
find
Stephen Thompson.
Chef Steph.
Chef Steph. Shout out to Chef Steph pulling up on us tonight, man. Been married to the Boogie Smurf.
Yeah, boy.
20 years.
Y'all see the shit she got to deal with, man. She's a strong woman, man.
Hey,
dealing
listen,
with my shit.
The fact that you sat on this panel tonight, you don't even know how much respect.
Oh, okay.
That everybody has for you.
I'm
before you
just
even
so
got
humbled
here.
To be here. Like, I'm really excited. Like, I was stoked. At first, I was like, oh, shit, he gonna ask me. And I was like, nah, he not. He cool. He cool.
We kept it cool.
And then he was like, you want to come? And I was like, well, I guess. I got my hair done today. So I was like, all right. So, yeah.
What Martin say?
You're looking like the bomb.
You're looking like the bomb.
So I was like, all right, I'll jump on.
We fuck with it.
But yeah.
Thank you for your experience. Thank you for your wisdom and your transparency more than anything else.
I appreciate it.
Yeah. How you feel with your wife on the set today?
I was excited.
You was, listen, can I say the truth?
I was excited.
You was a lot calmer today.
Oh, yeah. She keep me calm. I got in when I had to get in.
You didn't say nobody busted 60 nuts in the bitch. No. You didn't talk about ass today. He didn't talk about
no ass. That was Joy in the eating.
That was Joy in the eating.
I don't know. No, that was not. I don't know. That was definitely Joy. Every single time I come in here, something about some ass.
No.
Joy is definitely
what they say.
What is the bunions? The money.
Don't tell me somebody munching on some bunions.
Nah, they munching on bunions.
Yeah, I'm old. You can't say shit like that to me. I be thinking somebody munching on booty.
exactly how it goes.
All right, guys. So I want to ask you guys as a panel, what did you take out of tonight? Anybody got anything that you took from tonight? Because I got a lot that I took from tonight.
Oh, wow. It was
from the top of the domeski.
Shout out to Steven.
Emotional intelligence was a big one. Thank you, Rachel, for that. Shout out to Steven. Shout out to Rachel. Shout out to Boogie. Shout out to Steph. I love y'all, man. Y'all came in. Perfect panel, by the way. Perfect balance of a panel. All y'all got intelligence. Y'all have different experiences. We come from divorce, from married 10, married 20. Just from different aspects of life, West Coast, East Coast. You know what I'm saying? Well, I'm in the middle. I'm a St. Louis nigga. I'm just an ignorant nigga from the loop.
I spent most of my adult years here, though.
I agree. You did. And your boys grew up pretty. I remember the boys before y'all had four, y'all had two.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I remember when they was just little bitty babies. Remember we was hooping one time, and them niggas had some money. We gave them some money.
Boy.
And they was like, how old was they? Five,
They had
six?
To be like, yeah, like five.
And they was taking pictures with the money. Nigga was like, we were hooping, and they went over there.
Look, we turned around.
Folding the money up. And I was like, what the fuck is wrong with your boys? Why are they 30? In the club right now. Yep. But
taking pictures.
Shout out to Boog, man. Lil Boog.
Yeah, man.
He showed up. He turned out to be something, man.
Yeah, he did, man.
Shout out to Bink, man. Most intelligent grown motherfucker I ever known. Man. You know what I'm saying? I love y'all kids, by the way.
Rough boy.
Can I just give a shout out? I want to give a shout out.
Shoot.
Most people don't give a shout out to Story Girl.
Story to G.
And I just want to give a shout out to my baby girl. She held it down while I was gone. Nobody was around. She was the only girl holding it down. Like seven boys and one girl.
Oh, because
so,
y'all do be having some extras.
Yeah, nephews.
Shout out to Buddha. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
The OG Dion. You know what
Dion
I'm saying?
Dion don't play, man.
They got the coolest kids in the world, man. I'm going to tell you the truth. When I used to hang out with the boys and all the kids speaking different languages and shit. Niggas, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Black kids speaking Mandarin.
That's far.
You know what I mean? Like fluently.
Yeah, they fluent.
To me, I thought that was the flyest, dopest shit. You know what I mean? And I'm just testament to the parents, man.
Man.
Y'all did what y'all had to do to make y'all
put them ahead of the game.
What you got?
MCRD, April 6th. If you're a parent and you're in the military, mm-hmm. there is a free event where you can drop your kids off to me. I don't know how safe that is, but you can drop your kids off to me April 6th at MCRD and let them know that you're part of the Devil's Pup. And I will be teaching 40 kids how to fix vegetable biryani.
Biryani. Is that how you say that?
Yeah, that's an Indian dish.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Because I thought it was birria.
No.
Because somebody said barrera, and biryani. I was like, excuse me.
Yeah.
Y'all got some barrera in that motherfucker? Not at all. Thank you guys so much for showing up to the ballroom tonight, man. I had a really, really, really great conversation. To be honest with y'all, I did not know that it was almost 1 o'clock.
Yeah.
Oh, I expected it.
But that's how smooth the conversation went, in my opinion. Like, it just was flowing. So sometimes the show is an hour, sometimes it's two. It just depends on the people. And like I said, perfect cast, man. So I appreciate y'all. Final word. Let's get out of here.
Final word.
So tonight we talked about family time. When it comes down to family, I just want to let y'all know that family is what you make it. At the same time, let's not lose our tradition of family. Please, I'm begging y'all, man. Start having more things with your family. Start contacting people. I do things like, for example, when I go to work, I'll call my mom. I'll FaceTime my mom on my way to work. I'll FaceTime my dad on my way to work. When you're driving from place to place, you got 15, 20 minutes before you get there. Just call your people. Call your cousin. Check on your blood. You know what I'm saying? Your bloodline ain't going nowhere. I don't give a fuck what you think about how they treated you, what they did to you. Your bloodline is your bloodline. Please try your best to keep it strong. That's all I'm asking. When it comes to family time, also,
picking, choosing family is important. It's okay to live your life in peace. Your blood ain't out. Blood ain't always kinfolk. Skin folk ain't always kinfolk, is what they say in the South. So sometimes just because somebody is related to you does not mean you're obligated to their bullshit. So keep that in mind as well. Live free, live happy, but try your best to keep contact and keep some kind of fucking family going, man. We need it, especially in our community. We need it more than ever right now. I swear to God, we do. We also talked about Diddy. No Diddy. So we talked about Diddy. We talked about men falling to power. All I want to say is this. No matter how much success you get, don't let sex be the thing that ruin you. That's so crazy to me. You know what I mean? Like, you can literally get it whenever you want. So don't be weird about it. You know what I'm saying? Don't lose your life. Don't lose your fortune. People lose fortunes, and men have fallen for a lot of things. And don't let your addiction be one of those things. You know what I mean? So whatever Diddy going through, whether he's guilty or not, I just want to say that let us as a community be slow to judge, because you niggas ain't perfect either. You know what I mean? I'm not taking up for Diddy. I'm not taking up for R. Kelly, Michael Jackson, any of them people that fell from power. But at the same time, Kanye West didn't fall from nothing sexual. Again, when they want to get us, they're going to get us. The devil will never attack you where you're strong. Remember that. He only going to get you where you're weak. So if you have a weakness and it can be exposed, it will be. So I hope Diddy make it through this, believe it or not. I do. I hope he ain't guilty of a whole bunch of the bullshit that is being attested to him. What the medium said in the video about him being the scapegoat to somebody bigger than that, if that's going to happen, I hope it happens sooner than later. Because as a black man, I'm tired of our black men being demonized all the time. I just am. I'm sorry. I don't give a fuck. I'm just tired. I really am. And then we wrapped it up with marriage. Shout out to our married couple that pulled up on us today. Shout out to bro and sis, man. Shout out to Steven. Shout out to our divorcee in the building. Mm-hmm. Happily divorcee in the smile. I just like to hear the different perspectives, and I hope you guys did too, and learn something from it. You know what I'm saying? That patience is a big thing. That longevity is a big thing. And that understanding and communication is something that we all can learn and get better at. Emotional intelligence is something that we need to kind of study a little bit more, because you can grow physically, you can be fine and sexy, and mentally you can be the smartest person in the world. Spiritually, you can believe in God and you can just have so much discipline. But if you are not emotionally intelligent, you will fall. You will crumble. So keep that in mind when we're going forward, okay? Let's take care of ourselves. Ballroom!
Ballroom!
We about this bitch, baby. Final word. I hear the music. You know what time it is? What the fuck?
What we got going on?
I never known in all of my days the ballroom to go out like that. Oh,
here we go.
Gotta restart.
Okay, here we go.
Hey. Yeah.
He said, here we go. Ow. Welcome to the ballroom. Welcome to the ballroom.
Ow.
Yeah. And you can do what you want to do
in the ballroom.
Come on now. Steven, what you got for me, dog?
If you really want to talk your shit, you can talk your shit. You can talk your shit.
I love it. Let's get it.
In the ballroom.
This has been season one of the ballroom, man. There will not be a next week, right? We're taking like a month off.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We'll be back for season two coming up here in a few weeks, man. Shout out to Tyrone. Shout out to Tay, man. On the boys. Y'all did y'all thing today, man. Love y'all boys, man. We've been doing big things. Right now, we're just going to keep working on the show. We're going to keep making it better for y'all. We're going to keep bringing y'all content. And we'll be back in May. Yep. I'll see you then.
Yeah.
Good job, guys. Yeah.
Shoot us a show in Puerto Rico. Oh,
Puerto Rico!
Oh!
Hey. Why the fuck that show seemed like it was short, but it was long? This one.